me and others have planned doesn't go to plan, it should actually still be hilarious. So hopefully everything's gonna be okay.
He's gonna have a pretty epic death.
Sorry, I had to get that out. And oh, I just did that live.
Yep.
Oh, are we live? Okay. Nice. Well, just say when you want me to start.
And action.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Fate of the Diced as well beyond the Witchlight. I'm Dom the DM. And if the players could introduce themselves, starting from the left hand side.
He's done. I'm done. I'm Andy. I play Hourglass Rooney. I get it. Yeah, no idea. No, I play a Rooney, the ever lovable, happy go lucky
Okay. Sweeper.
Hi, I'm Nikki, and I play Sleeper, who's totally not distracted by shiny objects. Ooh, shiny!
And Alira, who is sadly her last session with us this week.
Aww. Yeah. I'm Natasha, I play Alira, the very happy fire genasi with a salamander called Steve.
Or not at the minute, because he's been stolen.
Well, evil Steve.
Yeah. I don't think you even got evil Steve at the minute, do you?
We have evil Steve.
In a mage hand.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Glint.
Hi, I'm Reg. I play Glint, the Earth Ganassi Barbarian.
Okay. I'm John. I play Benji, the very confused and excitable half-orc druid.
Excellent. So, when we left off last week, Aruni couldn't stop touching things, so it was just basically two big fights last session. First, you wound up Scabatha Nightshade so much, like literally wound her up with the key in her back.
I went down on her at least a couple of times.
Like. You did. She just kept knocking you down, and you kept getting back up.
Going back for round two, three.
And then you moved into the workshop. Like, the plan was to deal with Scabatha, that you would catch Will of the Feywild for her, and then she would give you Steve back, because she managed to capture Steve with her, well, Sowpig, one of her minions, captured Steve all the way back in session two.
Damn.
At the carnival. And you've had evil Steve with you since then, who has been relaying your movements and what you've been up to her. Since then, you decided, instead of going straight to try and capture Will, you sort of tried to have a bit of investigation. You broke into a room where Aruni tried to convince a very creepy living doll called Pincushion that he just wanted to find the toilet. She didn't believe you, so called for her guards, who happened to be some tin soldiers who were coming up the stairs and are trying to catch you. And that's where we left off after about, like, a round of combat last time. Does anybody have any questions, or shall we go straight back into this combat?
Guess straight back into combat.
Straight back into combat. In which case, Glint, you're up. Oh, you're in and out, aren't you? Because I just got that message from you. Glint, 2 seconds to say whether you're here or not, otherwise we'll come back to you, if that's all right. 1, 2. Okay, Alira, you're up.
So Alira is currently grappled, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Yep. I'm going to try and just get out of the grapple, because I don't like the fact that this doll is holding me. Weird, creepy.
That's fine.
Is that a strength check?
It is. Just bear with me while I bring up.
Stats for a weird, creepy doll.
Stats for a weird, creepy doll. That just became a thing for a whole week.
I don't think Deliria's getting out of this grapple, guys.
You will be getting out of the grapple. But make your roll. It's a DC of 6.
Oh, 10.
Yeah, you're out.
Woo!
Not the world's strongest creature.
But it is the start of your turn, so you will be taking 11 psychic damage.
No!
Before you're able to get out of the grapple.
Okay. God damn it, creepy doll!
That is your action to get out. Is there anything else you want to do?
I don't think I have any bonus actions. Let me double check. I'm pretty certain I don't. No, I do not. No, that's me done.
Okie dokie. Right. Moving on then. Benji.
Exactly.
You're, so you're in the rug of you're in the rug of smothering. So you can still actually attack the rug of smothering from being inside it, but you are grappled.
So it sounds silly.
It'll be a disadvantage. And the if you want to escape it, you can. It's an action, it's strength action, so athletics. But this one does have a higher DC, obviously, than being held onto by a creepy little doll.
Okay, okay. I'll go for the athletics check.
Okay.
And hope this.
Yeah, you're out. So if you've got anything that's a bonus action, you can. But you are going to take 10 bludgeoning damage.
Okay, can I ready Flame Blade?
You can.
For my next turn, and that will be it for now.
No worries. Right. Tin soldiers. So there's only two of these that can do anything. They're both going on a Rooney.
Happy days. So glad I stood in
there. A miss. A miss. A miss. 17.
I mean, I'd like to say that misses, but...
it doesn't, does it? Yeah. 8 bludgeoning damage.
Ooh. Okay.
Okay, that's then done. Sweeper, everything rests on you.
I'd like to firebolt the creepy doll.
Go for it.
Fourteen.
Let me just bring up her AC. Yeah, easily hits. She's already taken a bit of a beating as well. Oh, it's a big hit, but it's not quite enough. Have you got anything else?
No. That's my goal.
That's your goal. Okay. Rug of Smothering is going to try and smother Benji again, seeing as you're right there, I'm afraid.
Okay.
But that's a miss. That's a massive miss.
That's what we like to hear.
No panic there.
To be fair, Benji's got a low AC class, so that's got to be in like at least a 4, if not below.
It was a 7, and your AC is 13. So,
there we go.
Yeah. okay, Aruni.
And the rug's ended its turn.
The rug has ended its turn. It only gets that one little thing it's got.
Okay, can it make a Wisdom DC 14 save?
I don't know, it's a rug.
To see if it's charmed. I'm hoping it's got 4 Wisdom, it's a rug.
It does. Would you like to know its result of that check?
Yes.
-3.
So it is now charmed.
It botched, and it has... No, it didn't botch. It got a 1, and it has a -4 on its wisdom. So you've charmed a rug.
Mm-hmm. So
I'm not going to say it. I'm not going to say it.
Please don't.
I need to say it.
Ah,
So it now regards you as a friendly acquaintance.
Yeah, it now stands there, has zero speeds, incapacitated. It's in a dreamy stupor. It has to repeat its save every turn, and anybody can hit it, and it will still stay standing there doing nothing.
That's fine.
So Rug is out of the game, hopefully. Mm.
It's then, not a whole new world for you, Rug.
No. And then Rudy's going to swing.
Oh, God.
You know? Didn't like that one? Let's try.
Not really like now.
No.
That was a 13 on a toy.
Yeah, no, I think that's a miss, but let me just bring it up just to double check. Yeah, they've got pretty high AC because they're made of metal.
Yeah. And Rooney's like, but I got the rug. I did the rug thing. And then he's just going to stand in the doorway and wait to get hit some more.
Yeah, that's fair enough. Yeah. I was about to say, you can always try and move back. You might take an opportunity attack. But...
Well, I was going
to
maybe move.
But everybody's in your way.
Yeah, I was
you can move there. Yeah. Oh, yeah, well, you still... Yeah. I mean, you'll be taking an opportunity attack from this one, but not from that one.
Yeah, so that's what... Yeah, we'll try that.
Yeah, that's a miss.
Yeah.
13.
And then... gives Glint an opportunity to come and join the tin part soldier party.
Creepy Doll's going to risk some opportunity attacks just for the sake of coming and giving Sweeper a hug. A big hug. So, opportunity attacks from Illyria, Glint, if you'd like. Oh, and then it'll be Glint's turn.
Yeah.
When did say Glint, he was, when did say, shall I just move?
Didn't say he was going to be back, but...
Yeah.
I've got his character sheet if you want me to roll an opportunity attack for him.
Illyria is going to do a firebolt.
Yeah, you do a firebolt and then. Glint, just shout up when you're back, okay, if that's all right, and then we can just squeeze you in, as it were.
He's unmuted, so he might be back.
I am kind of back.
Okay.
13?
We'll hit.
Awesome. I need different dice, because this is the one time I don't have all of my dice out. D10. It's
1d10. 8 points
of fire damage.
Well, she's dead. You said firebolt, didn't you?
Yep.
Excellent. So she's just wandering on fire with her plastic face melted, outstretched towards Sweeper, going, hug me, love me. As her face melts.
Somehow that might be creepier.
I know we were joking about this before we started, but I've actually just rolled a natural 20.
Oh, nice. Yes.
I like it.
Cool. Glint, have a go while you're here.
Have two goes,
because, yeah, we had to skip past you because you weren't around. So
Come jump in the doorway and hit some toy soldiers.
I think that's 21 damage.
On that toy soldier? Okay, excellent.
On whatever my first attack was.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, we'll just say you sort of move there, and you have obliterated that toy soldier, knocked it into little pieces, so it clatters to the bottom of the staircase. Okay, anything else? Have another go?
You sure?
Yeah, because, like I say, we had to skip past you, and now you're actually next in line anyway, so it's two goes in one for you.
14?
We'll miss a toy soldier, I'm afraid.
That's fine.
Okay. Anything else?
I can't remember what my wild surge was doing last week.
Neither can I. Teleporting last time I remember you doing anything.
Yes.
That was when we were fighting the witch, I remember that.
I don't think you've done one this fight, have you?
Not so far, I don't think.
No, I'm not sure you have said you were raging or anything this time.
No, I've not seen you rage at this time. So, bonus action, rage.
You can rage, yeah.
He did rage, because if you look further back in the chat, it's got minus to the third... no, actually. No, that was the other fight.
Yeah, there's nothing in this fight.
No, you're right.
Yeah.
But would you like to rage?
Oh, I have raged. It's okay.
Okay.
Okay, so is that you, Dundun, then?
Yeah.
For the minute? Okay. Illyria.
Not really much I can do while I'm stood in here.
There's a rug.
There is a rug. Is the rug...
And will only count as difficult terrain if you want to get past him, but... It'll just be double movement.
How many toy soldiers are left?
Two. And the cat. But the cat's basically a non-combatant.
But the carpet currently doesn't prove...
The rug is not doing anything right now yet. The rug is sort of swaying side to side in a dreamy stupor. Drugs can definitely do that. Rugs probably can't.
Okay, I'm going to firebolt the rug then, seeing as that's what's in here.
Okay, go for it.
I'm going to do that. That is, mental maths is really bad. 21.
Well, it's, yep.
Awesome. And I need my pre-turn. Yes, I can turn. Seven points of fire damage.
Okay. You have singed the rug.
That's me done.
And that's you done. Okay. Benji.
Okay, I'm just going to flame blade the carpet.
Yeah. Hits.
Okie dokie. That's 11 fire damage.
11 damage. Excellent. Anything else?
No, I think that's pretty much about it.
Nice, you done? Okay. Tin soldiers. So that one's going to move up and around, and that one's going to follow him up. So we're going to have one on a Rooney. Well, it'll be two because they make two attacks each. So it'll be two on a Rooney and two on Glynn. So two on a Rooney. 16.
16 is my AC.
6 bludgeoning damage. And the next one's a miss. And 2 on Glint. 15 will miss you, Glint, I think. I don't know if you're there or not, but it will miss you because your AC is 17. Yeah. And 12 will miss. Yeah. Okay, so that's them done. Sweeper.
Kill a rug.
I'll shoot the rug.
Aruni, why have you just stepped on top of Glint?
Just so that it shows on the squad screen better.
Okay.
So you can see in both rooms.
See both rooms now. I'll move back in a minute.
No, you won't. We'll swap places to make it.
There you go. Yeah.
Okay.
I will not.
Sorry, I wasn't watching the Twitch.
That's all right.
You're going to shoot the rug. You miss the rug. You somehow do that with advantage because it's charmed and it's just like swaying there.
It is incapacitated.
It is incapacitated, yeah, so that should be with advantage. Yeah, that's a hit. Can anyone guess that I want to get this combat out of the way pretty quick?
Yep.
-8. Yep, it's a badly burned rug.
Chunky carpet. It's got some...
it's a pretty chunky carpet. It just doesn't do a lot other than, like, smother you. It's a rug of smothering. Okie dokie, anything else from you, Sweeper?
That's me.
Okay. Rug of Smothering is going to redo its save. This should be entertaining.
It's only 4.
Do we reckon we can get less than a -3? Oh no, it's a 4 this time.
Hey! Who knew?
That was a good roll! That was a good roll! And Aruni.
Aruni will take a swing. And probably miss. But... Oh. 17.
That's a hit.
That hits a tin soldier. Ooh.
Mm. That's its AC.
8.
Yeah, they're a bit tough as well, though, I'm afraid. So that's a good hit, but not enough. Because this one, these two are undamaged so far.
Yeah. No, we'll take that.
Anything else?
No, that's it.
That's it. Dal is gone. Glint, are you about?
Yeah.
Yeah, your turn.
Swing away.
I'm swinging recklessly as well, so next time you'll need to attack with advantage on me.
Okay.
16?
Not quite.
Ooh, they're as hardy as I am.
Yeah.
I think that's it.
Okay. Fair enough.
Illyria. Killer.
Illyria.
Right. I'm going to firebolt the rug. Because it's what I do. 21 to hit.
That might hit.
I think the rug might be a bit burnt now. It is a 1d10. It's a 4. 4 points of fire damage to the rug.
It's still not quite down, I'm afraid. Just bear with me, because I am doing something right now.
Die, rug. Die.
Benji.
That I can't remember how to
nip on a rug to death.
it's coming.
Nope, nuts. I wanted to try something and I can't remember how to do it. just give me 30 seconds.
Oh, you're good, you're good.
Leary is going to try and talk to the rug in the meantime.
Yes, chat away to the rug.
I mean, it's charmed. It can't talk back. If it could talk in the first place, we'll never know. It's too late. It's just going to dangle with tassels. It can't. It can't move.
Sway once if you agree with our statement. Sway twice if you don't. Okay, that's swaying 6 times. I don't quite know what that means. So where did you get your patterning done? Like, was it in Witchlight? Was it in Feyrealm? You just keep swaying. You're not helping. I will continue to talk to this rug until you're ready, guys.
That's fair enough. I'm ready. I need to send a quick message on my phone, but I am ready. Have you got anything else up your sleeve? Because that rug is very poorly.
No, because Illyria only has attacks. She doesn't have any bonus actions. She's because of level 3.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, you've hurt that rug so badly, he's afraid of you.
Ooh.
Oh, never mind.
They stood there with like a pair of scissors, like aiming it after. It's like, I will chop the tassels off.
Benji!
Okay, so I am going to take a cheeky chance here and belly flop the rug with a nipple poke.
I like it.
I'm just going to sort of try and like bounce off the wall to get a bit more height as I like go to land on it.
So are you trying to stab the thing with your nipples?
Yeah,
for it. Absolutely go for it.
That got you, but the afraid rug pun didn't get you.
I've just had a conversation with a rug. So like...
Oh, it's an 18 on the nipple poke.
It is that hits that you have taken a rug out with your nipples. It only had 1 HP left.
Wait, that's an actual move?
Yep. Look at it, nipple poke is on there.
Yeah, it's on his character sheet.
It's his unarmed attack, nipple poke.
Yep.
Oh, Jesus. So to be fair, my nipples have actually taken out more enemies than Benji has himself.
Yep.
Just taken down a barleywog and now a carpet.
Yeah.
Yep.
Is that something to be proud of, though?
Mm. Yes!
Claim to fame, isn't it?
Why would you never be proud of that? I would. I mean, that's an image in your brain, isn't it?
Oh, I stabbed this guy to death with my nipple.
Nipples. Yeah. Yeah. not just a guy, but a carpet.
Carpet. Yeah.
So I felt threatened by a carpet, so I've killed it with my nipples.
So to be fair, that's actually also Benji's highest combat role the whole campaign.
I like it. Oh no, I've seen who's next to go.
Oh, that's gone.
Tin soldiers.
Right. It is the tin soldiers, I'm afraid. So first two on Glint with advantage. Miss. Next two on Aruni. Miss.
Oh, yeah.
That was... Yeah.
We'd like to hear.
Yeah. Okay, sweeper. Right, where's that thing gone? There.
Can I?
You do know when I'm not here, you're going to get all of this in chat, right? Yeah.
Can I fly like above one of the statues and be like firebolt, pew?
You can just do it over Rooney's head. He's not exactly tall.
Yes, you can. The doorway is miraculously just high enough for a baby Arakora to fly over the top of Aruni and go pachoo.
I'll just squeeze you, then go pachoo.
Yep, that definitely hits. Good damage. But like I say, these guys are fairly tough, but that one is looking a little melty.
As opposed to like non-melty.
Yeah.
Technical term, yeah?
Yeah. The metal. Metal starts off a little bit melty before going full melty.
We don't want to see any toys so just going the full melty.
Anything else from you, Sweeper?
Oh, that's me.
That's you. Okay, Aruni.
Aruni's just going to swing away and hope to kill one. Oh, 19.
Nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, easily hits. And that was the one directly in front of you?
Yep, the one that we've hit.
And you have managed to just kill it. It had 10 HP left. You have taken that 10 off. And again, it clatters to the floor there, just to create a bit of space, really.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah, anything else?
There. No, I'll stay there.
You want to stay there? Okay.
Needs to happen.
Okay, creepy doll's dead. Glint!
I'll step and swing.
Mm-hmm.
Always bringing the
tone down. Tiny sombreros. Like one of them charity calendars, just very, very different.
Oh, that could be an idea for next year. We could do one of those.
Yeah.
Yeah.
When the fae goes wild.
Oh, I like it. I like it.
Thanks.
I've just sent you a message in the Discord chat.
Oh dear.
Oh, are you?
What are you rolling over there? Two nat 20s. What is going on?
Nice. Oh, you're on proper dice as well, are you? Sorry, yeah. I didn't realise. Yeah, okay, two nat 20s. I mean, I'm going to need you to roll me damage for that because I wouldn't even know where to start. Do you reckon in your experience it would be more than 27?
No.
Not. Is it D10?
21.
21, that's close.
Close! Oh. Okay, yeah, you take a really good, massive swing out of that. And you got hewn big chunks of metal off it. That you, Glenn?
Yeah, that's me.
That's you. Elaria, there is one combatant left alive.
But I need to get past a Rooney. I'm glad to get to it.
Should be tall enough to shoot over it.
I say he is difficult terrain, so you could stand on him and then go here to the back where there isn't anybody stood, and then fire over the top of what.
I'm gonna climb over a Rooney. Dude, just get out of the way, man.
Get what? Oh, God's sake.
And I'm going to cast Firebolt at the silver thing.
Fourteen. No, that's a miss, I'm afraid.
Damn it, that's me done.
Yeah.
That's luckily, because Glint is a silver Earthkensai.
Yeah. Did you get the right one?
I meant that.
Blasted in the back of the head.
The one with the mustache.
Yep.
That one.
Okay. Benji, I'm not sure there's much you can do from there unless there's anything magical you can think of. He's just going to be like crawling through bodies and end up at the bottom of Illyria's feet, I think, if you tried that.
Illyria just sort of like stares over at Benji as like you can try and climb over and see how far you get.
Yeah, no, I'm just going to sort of stand there wondering what's gone wrong with life.
Contemplating your existence, that's fine.
I was quite happy in my village, being the village idiot. Now I'm here.
Now you've got competition for that title.
Okay, one last tin soldier left standing. He's going to go for Glint, because Glint is tough. Miss.
Took a huge chunk out of him.
Oh no, it was advantage, wasn't it? One hit for floor bludgeoning damage. For four bludgeoning damage. So down to two. Yeah, two.
You might want to put your teeth back into that one.
Yeah.
No.
It's got Granny Nightshade's teeth
in. Yeah.
Borrowed them.
Why would Granny Nightshade have taken her teeth out of Rooney?
Can't hide it, that's what I'm saying.
No.
Yeah.
Oh god.
Yeah. There's a reason she kept getting me back up.
Okay, that's them done. Sweeper. I think the last shot might be yours.
Come on, Sweeper, no pressure.
Oh,
I'm you can do it.
Sweeper's having a sugar rush. Firebolt.
Mm-hmm. Hey, no. Anything else?
I'm good.
No.
No.
Yeah. I did do it. Hey, no. Aruni.
Swing. Oh, no.
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 Parlay? No, okay.
It's a bit stuck, to be fair.
Yeah. Glint, it's your turn. Kill it.
Yeah, Glint.
Come on, Glint.
You did such a good job on the first one, which you'd be lucky to have this one.
23.
That hits.
Nice.
Now don't roll less than 7.
12 damage.
Yeah.
Woo!
Completely batter it. And the only thing that's left is the poor cat here that runs off going, please don't hurt me. I'm just a cat with the bass and drum going around, going boom, boom, boom.
Oh.
Get him.
He's going to the GM layer.
Oh, dear.
He goes back into his little box. And you're out of initiative.
Well, that was fun.
I still need
to go to the loop.
You want to go to the loop?
No. Aruni.
Okay. Yeah, you can. I mean, you can just go for a wee in that room if you really want to, but...
I mean, there's a carpet. You can just pee on the carpet.
The dead carpet.
It's on fire as well, so you can put it out.
Yeah.
Pee on the creepy doll if you have to put it out.
Right, what are we supposed to be doing, Illyria?
Right. Benji's going to cover his eyes regardless of what Aruni is doing with his tackle.
Yeah. It's dwarf-sized.
Illyria, do you want to make me a perception check?
Yes.
Sorry, Nikki.
Have a quick look. What is my perception? 22.
That's good. You hear a faint echoing whisper coming from the back of Gloom Church, which is this big tree log that you're in, guiding you towards the northeast to a room there. You don't know quite what's going on there, but you know it's speaking to you and you should be heading in that direction.
So is that through that door there, or is it up the stairs?
Hang on, I went all the way to where I wanted you to go and didn't see where you were pinging.
Kids in the creepy door room.
They ran away when you started fighting. They hid.
That's okay. I wanted to get them out.
Yeah, so it's through that door. And then when you get through that door, it's through that door.
Okay.
And then through that door. It's a fair trek, to be fair.
It's through this door that you can see, and then through this door that you can't see, and then through that door that you can't see.
You can't see, yes, exactly.
Into this corridor.
But I can see all the doors.
Illyria, where are you going? Illyria, what are you doing?
Illyria just hasn't even, turned to look at the rest of them. She's just, wandered off.
Is there something shiny this way?
Probably, knowing Illyria.
Yeah, exactly. Or a pumpkin head.
I was going to say, the pumpkin seeds are talking to her.
Guys, come on, come this way. There's...
But there's a door here.
I mean, it's locked.
There are lots of doors in here.
Yeah, the doors you can see on your right and left are locked.
Fine.
Try and open them if you want. We can try and lockpick them.
The two on your right are actually unlocked.
Nope.
So you're east. But there's just an array of boxes and things in there.
Looks boring.
They're storerooms.
Anything lootable?
If you want some firewood.
No, I'm good.
Illyria!
We've had my fire fonder.
We always want the firewood.
We always want firewood. How are you going to cook things? What, Illyria?
And this way. This way. Stop.
Why are there tentacles coming out of the wall? I don't want to know.
It's tree roots. You're in a tree.
You said that last time. The boxes had toys in them. Illyria, where have you gone?
Stop. We need to go this way. I can hear something, and it's...
Pretty sure we were supposed to go back that way into the garden.
Follow the seed if green ping.
I can hear something as well. It's a Rudy shouting at you.
Yeah. Stop.
Let me just briefly describe this room, though, because this is a fairly important room. Just bear with my get to the bit, because this is the kitchen that isn't too exciting right now, but may well become exciting later. This squalid kitchen is carved out of the trunk of the fallen oak. A large clay oven sits in the middle of the room, surrounded by crowded shelves laden with forest fungi, jars of pickle grubs, animal skulls, and mouldy cookbooks. Sickly sweet vapours emerge from a cauldron that rests atop the oven. A young human girl, shackled to the work table, is hard at work peeling potatoes. Set into the floor nearby is a padlocked iron grate through which you can hear a small male voice say, "Don't worry about me right now." And also you can see this gentleman over here. He's just sweeping up the floor going, "Oh, don't mind me, I'm just a cleaner."
Of course he is, called Trigger.
It's nice to see people actually working calmly. And
he's had that broom for 30
years. It's just the kitchen. People need to eat. They're The kids need to eat.
I knew it was coming. Right, why are we in the kitchen, Illyria? Are you just hungry? We follow you because you're hungry.
I was just describing the room. The real thing is this way. Follow this.
I mean, does no? Can we look in the hole?
You just see a kind of meek but pretty proud wood elf there. He just seems fairly chilled with his situation at the minute. Wants to be sort of left alone with his own thoughts.
It's like the satire that was over at the other place. Mm.
Oh god, I think I've still got his telephone number.
Yeah, please tell us he got close this time.
He wasn't. He was clothed.
Who?
And so you the wood elf until you lot started asking and then he stripped off.
Oh.
Mm. And up the stairs.
What's in the desk?
I say there's a desk. You think Alira is walking past the desk?
What's in the desk?
Fine. Let's have a look.
Have you met Alira?
Yeah, that was never happening.
Not nailed down.
A staircase runs along the wall of this circular room and climbs to an upper level. Tucked behind curtains of moss and ivy are numerous bookshelves bearing ancient tombs. And built into each of these bookcases is a tall oval mirror in a wooden frame. Flickering candlelight emanates from the eye sockets of a human skull resting on the open roll-top desk. If you would like to loot the desk, you are allowed to.
Yes, I would like to loot the desk.
When you said bookshelves with lots of tombs on, I was like, are they little like pixie coffins?
Yeah. Or little mushrooms.
So, what you do find in the desk is a varnished human eyeball inside the lower half of a small hourglass that hangs like a pendant from a necklace made of woven hair. You find a black feathered quill with a bone tip that magically produces its own ink.
Ooh.
The ink is the crimson colour of fresh blood until it dries, whereupon its colour changes to sepia.
That's pretty cool.
I'm afraid.
I found was some dusty books.
Mm.
Hey, Rooney, you sure you don't want this necklace? I mean, it look pretty cool on you. She's just going to hold it up and...
That's not a human... No. You magic people are weird.
I just want to keep an eye on you, that's all.
I'm definitely not wearing it now.
I'm gonna go up the stairs.
If you all move your characters to where I'm pinging, because the map sort of does a bit of a teleporty thing, or you can gather yourselves together and I'll just drag you across. Well, Benji's managed it, Illyria's managed it, the rest of you manage it, or Rudy's managed it. I'm gonna have to drag Sweeper. There we go.
Sleeper
and Glint.
And Glint's gone outside.
He's gone outside for a flag break.
Doesn't want to come in.
Yeah.
I was following the path.
Yeah.
Come on, Glint.
Yes,
Benji, I was close.
Yeah, Benji, why have you run towards the cloaked figure?
Because my map is tiny and I cannot see nothing.
Yeah.
That is one of Granny Nightshade's ghouls that has seen you and gone to report that you are now in her bedroom.
Oh, glitched in her bed.
Yeah.
Not the time for a nap right now.
I mean, investigation check with advantage here because you've been here before.
Oh,
sorry, what?
I'm making a joke. Sorry, it's fine.
Okay.
But yes, just to describe the room, almost everything about this bedroom is orderly, from the bed with the patchwork quilt to the ornamental pigs arranged in a neat row on the dresser. Such tidiness is at odds, however, with a decaying dollhouse sitting on the bedside table. This 3-foot-tall edifice has seen better days and is now besmirched by peeling paint, mould and rot. Behind the dollhouse, by the window, moths flutter inside a large bell jar. Facing one another along the outer wall are a pair of doors. Next to the door closest to the staircase is a wooden rocking cradle with a neatly folded blanket in it. However, what you were hearing, Illyria, with those whispers is coming from through this door here.
Rooney's going to come, but he's going to mess up the bed on the way past.
Mm.
Just because he feels like that will annoy everybody.
So, O'Leary, you have been led to a long, thin package that is addressed to a lady named Skylar.
Ooh, I'm going to take the long, thin package.
Attached to it.
I'm going to take the note and read it.
And read it? Do you want me to say out loud what it says, or...?
I'm going to pop it in my pocket for now, and then I'll tell everybody what it says when I go back out. But I'm going to take the package, have a look at what it is.
And you are in a bedroom now, and you don't think anyone's going to disturb you for a while, so if you would like to take a short rest, you can now. And I might advise you, if you like, use all of your hit dice, because there could be a big fight coming up, and it will be the last one before you get a long rest.
Is that Mechanical Sparrow actually there?
No, I accidentally dragged that out before. I do apologise. That should be in here. The room O'Leary has just gone into is an aviary where the hags send messages to each other with the help of these mechanical sparrows.
Can I steal a couple of the mechanical sparrows?
I mean, it's a creature. So you can try and kill it. But you can't take one. It won't go with you. It will keep trying to peck you.
I'll leave it.
Yeah. It's essentially a hawk that's mechanical.
Yeah, I was hoping it was like a little wind-up one, but that's okay. Look at these people using hit dice.
Let me know when you've all had your little short rest.
While we're just chilling out, Illyria is going to just mosey on over to stand next to Sweeper. And she's going to have a bit of a heart-to-heart moment with Sweeper. Going to put a hand on Sweeper's shoulder and say that no matter what happens, you are the glue that holds this group together. And they will do anything for you. Take advantage of it.
Why would you lie to a child?
Have you seen a Rooney?
I'm sorry, yeah. How many times have you guys protected Sweeper? She is the glue of this group. She holds all of you together.
I've tried to kill her on several occasions.
He's not lying.
Can I
only get other people to kill her, but yeah.
Can I have a hug?
I'm gonna give Sweeper a nice little hug.
Where was the neatly arranged pegs on the dresser? I'm going to go mess those up.
I love you!
So Rooney's just ransacking the neat bedroom.
There was a doll's house. There might be stuff in there that you can give to people for that exchange thing.
Oh.
Might be able to find Steve a little dress in the doll's house.
Yes.
Yeah,
is there a doll?
You can Steve. You can do all of this later. Let Illyria do a thing.
Sweeper, can you go and have a look to see if there's any clothes for Steve? That's a really good idea. I think when you see him next, he needs a new outfit. And then she's going to mosey on over to Glint, because Glint doesn't get out of this either. And she's going to turn to Glint and say, I've never met someone that can eat the amount that you do. And it's impressive. And I know you'll do everything you can to protect these guys. And just know I'm really glad that I'm your friend.
I mean, friend's a strong word.
I consider you a friend.
Yeah, I get that a lot, but friend's a strong word.
Thanks, Glenn. Thanks. I'll remember that, thanks. And then she's gonna go to a Rooney.
Who's been trying to hide. It's not worked.
You are not getting out of this. You are also getting a one-to-one with Illyria today. And I know that, you know, you take the mick out of me and you take the mick out of the rest of the group. And I know that you actually really do love us all. And just, you know,
look after Sweeper and the rest, and just keep being you, even if you are a bit of a... Never mind.
I agree with you after the never mind. Yeah.
I also see you as a really good friend.
No, so
thank
don't.
You. Oh, thank you for your friendship.
You had to ruin it. You had to ruin it.
And then Benji. Benji, actually, I wanted to have a chat with you downstairs, if that's all right. Do you mind having a
chat?
This is where she goes all crazy witch and attacks Benji and kills him.
Yeah. Evil Steve has possessed evil Illyria.
So where do I need to take my token?
I don't know if you can see me, Kenyon. There you go. Do you mind coming into the kitchen? So I think that actually let's go grab a coffee. I think that'd be quite nice.
I mean, you've got to have a drink, so cheers. VDA monster.
Can you see all right, Benji? Do you want, I'll drag you.
I don't have a drink.
I've just got I've just got like a map that's under 5 centimeters big at this point.
So Nikki, you've got a drink.
That's all right, that's enough.
I've just had one.
Crack out the iron brew. Oh, it's not iron brew. What is going on?
Not bright orange. What is that?
lemon and strawberry.
Nice. Benji, I actually wanted to have a chat with you aside from the others, because I actually think of you as a really good friend, and you protected me, and you've done so much for the group, and I just wanted to let you know that I really appreciate everything you've done for the group. And I was just wondering if something's been bugging me recently. The unicorn horn. Do you mind if I have a look at it quickly?
Yeah, Benji's going to hand over the unicorn horn.
I'm going to take the unicorn horn. Okay. Yeah, it's definitely a unicorn horn. Illyria reaches into her pocket and she takes out one of the magic beans that she's been holding onto for a long time. Pops it in her mouth. They're quite tasty beans. And she looks up at Benji. She gently places a hand on his chest, avoiding the nip, and says, "Thanks for that." And she reaches into his chest and rips out his heart.
Benji's just gonna sort of go an even paler green and collapse to the floor.
I believe it does 83 points of damage.
Is that more than twice your HP, Benji?
Yes.
Yeah, it's funny how these things work out.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I should probably go. I might hang around for a little bit. I'm just going to chill in the kitchen.
Yeah. I mean, you're quite far away now. Do you want to, like, the rest of you can hear the blood-curdling scream from Benji as he gets his heart ripped out from him.
And I guess we just start running after looking at each other.
Look, can you remember where you're going? I'll drag you. Hang on.
Dun, dun, dun.
Jiggy's still there going, "Don't mind me, I'm just a cleaner. Try not to make too much of a mess."
And Illyria is now not Illyria.
Illyria is not Illyria.
No, I didn't like her.
Would everybody like to roll for initiative?
Redeemed unicorn.
What?
I think that's what we have to do. Nikki made the rules.
What?
What?
On Twitch, somebody redeemed unicorn.
Oh, you got to do the unicorn sign in front of your head.
Benji Khan is dead. But he would if he
wasn't dead.
I do want to point out, Illyria did think that you were a really good friend. It's just ulterior motives.
So she killed you after stealing everything?
Yeah, essentially.
Ben,
you don't need the unicorn horn for anything, right?
Well, guess the answer is we hope not.
It was the cook, right?
Yeah.
Illyria got 15 for thingy.
Trigger, what did you do?
Yeah, okay. Don't mind me, I'm just a cleaner.
Who killed Illyria? What happened?
Trigger went batshit and killed him.
Aye, crazy lady came down here, gave her a heart to heart, and then just straight up bloody murdered him.
Crazy lady.
And you just see Illyria stood on the other side just waving, and instead of her bright white eyes, they're now jet black.
Did anybody else see the... No?
I don't know. Is everybody you rolled for initiative? Yeah, because Benji's dead, isn't he?
Oh, yeah, Benji's dead.
Yeah. That's
everybody. It's not going to do anything.
It's the four of you.
Yeah.
Can my foot at least be twitching a little bit?
Yeah. There is a very agitated wood elf down in the prison at the minute, but he is kind of locked in the prison there right now. Okay, well, Skylar, you came top. Sorry, Illyria, whatever we're going to call you.
I mean, you can call me Skylar at this point, so unless you guys haven't, you know, been around for a bit, I'm Skylar. I'm actually I have a really good friend who happens to be the witch called something or other.
I mean, you're clearly best friends with her, yeah. I see that.
Angelin.
We know her well, the witch called something rather.
Yeah. Endelin.
I needed to get you here. Otherwise, how are me and my friend meant to defeat you in the solar eclipse soon? So,
sorry. What? Are you Evil Steve?
Evil Steve's my friend.
I didn't like that gecko, I knew it.
So I am going to unwrap the staff that I took from upstairs. And I'm going to use... Where is it? Sorry, bear with me. I've not used this item before, so...
Yeah, you're okay. You can basically do 3 Eldritch blasts with it.
Awesome. I'm going to do 3 Eldritch Blasts, because there's 3 people in front of me. Yeah. And Benji's dead.
What did Trigger do to you?
I think Trigger needs to hide.
Trigger is hiding. Trigger is cowering behind this bench right now.
So do I still... I still have to roll to hit, though, don't I?
You do, I'm afraid.
Let's go for Sweeper first. Mm-hmm. So Sweeper was a bonus to attack and damage is 15.
Miss.
Okay, we'll do Glint. Oh, that's a miss. That's 11. And let's do...
Here comes the favouritism.
Natural
20. I miss 3. On 4 of them.
Oh no.
That's really pants. That's a really good weapon as well, which is really annoying. Why can't I do that?
This is great. I could just go for a wee right now and let you just fight it out. I should do that more often. okay, anything else? Because I think you can multi-attack.
I can multi-attack.
So you could always do another 3.
I'm going to try and do another 3. Oh, I get +2 on it as well, so that's 4. Okay, so it's not +1. That's good to know.
Sweeper, kill her.
Right, Sweeper first. Is a 17.
Hit.
You get... Ooh, this is cool. 1d6 and 1d8. You get force damage 5 and 6 lightning damage, I think it is. Yeah, I think so. So 11 points of damage in total.
Ouch.
Then let's do a Rooney next. It's a miss, that's a 9. And let's do a Glint next. Is 11, so that's also going to be a miss.
So So it's just sweep you don't like, we got it.
Yeah.
I mean, to be fair, just joining the club.
Yeah.
I am going to leave it at that now, and I'm just going to stand in the door.
Okay, sweeper.
I'd like to do...
Chiller with fire.
I'd like to do Witch Bowl on her.
Okay.
She is a witch.
Why is that rolling twice?
I think I'm going to have to go with the first one, I'm afraid, and that will miss, won't it? Nah.
Yeah, first one misses. Yeah. Just about.
Anything else?
Bonus action, hide somewhere.
Yeah, first, join first, Trigger. Six. Join Trigger in the corner.
Join Trigger in the corner.
You just sort of stand behind Trigger.
Yeah. So I'll need a stealth roll, and that'll be on your passive perception, unless, Nat, you want to roll against it with a perception check. Wow. I wouldn't even bother, Nat. I think Sweepy
yeah.
I think she's got it. Sweepy's gone. Where did the bird go?
She's underneath Benji's dead body, just using it. Camouflage.
Using as a shield.
Glint, kill her.
Okay, Glint, yeah.
Well, I'll use my last rage of the day. Sorry, just looking for the right dice.
Hey, Benji.
Can't believe you just ripped Benji's heart out.
Me and Dom have been planning this all day.
We're planning to kill Benji all day.
Benji wanted to go.
All day.
Illyria needs to make a constitution save.
Okay. Constitution is plus two. Okay.
Benji.
22.
Was that 22?
That was 22.
Son of a...
Son of a... What?
I'll run over and just hit it with an axe. I'll tell you what happened. A bolt of light shoots out of my chest and hits you, but you ignore it.
Awesome.
Nineteen to hit.
Yeah, that hits.
For a total of 8 damage.
I'm going to use my reaction to that, which is Eldritch Escape. If you take damage when holding the staff, you can use 3 of the charges from the Eldritch Staff. Turn invisible and teleport yourself along with any equipment you're wearing or carrying up to 60 feet to an unoccupied space. So Skylar is invisible. She's going to move over there. But you don't know where she is. I think it's a Rooney next.
It is a Rooney. Sorry, I was just sending a quick message to John.
Well, a Rooney is going to shout, is anybody going to help look at Trigger cowering in the corner? Look at Benji's dead body and then decide to double in size.
I mean, we're in the kitchen, start throwing flour.
Yeah, I like it.
That's a good idea. Yeah. I like that.
So yeah, Rooney's going to bonus action Giant's Might and double in size.
Nice. Where are you hiding?
And then he's going to go over to the grate and see if he can open up the grate to release the elf.
You can just make me an athletics check.
Athletics.
Yeah, that easily does it. You rip open the bars, and you release a gentleman. Would Rodney like to introduce himself? And then roll for initiative?
Yep, I am Rodney, a Wood Elf Ranger Hunter. Yeah, and I am just going to try and help the best I can at this point.
Yeah, you might just want to get out of here. This is just not... Look at what she did to that guy. And now I can't see her.
That guy was weak. He had it coming.
I mean, he did try and drown me, so you're not wrong. And then Irina's just going to hold an attack in case somebody appears.
Is that an extra action you can do because you used your action to bust?
No, you're right. Yeah.
Sorry.
No, it's fair. It's fair. So that's my go then.
Okay. Skylar.
So I'm now not invisible because it goes to the next turn. So I suddenly appear again. I'm going to use. Where is it? What am I using?
That Eldritch staff does have two of the normal charges.
Okay. I'm going to use Burning Hands. And I'm going to point it in this direction.
There's a surprise.
So
I killed you twice in one night.
Yeah. Just going to set Benji's body on fire.
Okay, so I'm going to use that. So Burning Hands is a dex save.
Oh, yeah.
I need...
Really good at those.
A 12.
Very, very dexterous.
Really looks dexterous.
Yeah, he does, yeah. He's just a little fat dwarf. It's not happening. How much fire damage? Yeah. Oh, she's having to get more dice. I don't like this at all. Can we not?
It is worth stressing that I'll tell you later.
Oh, I'm aiming to kill.
3d6. 3d6.
Okay, so it's just a Rooney that gets the hit, yeah? Because the dex is 12, so me to beat it.
Who else is...
Okay, that's probably the best roll I've had in a while. That is 17 points of damage.
Jesus.
I knew we weren't friends. I knew it. I knew.
And then, so I think that one, I think that's an action. That's not a... and I'm gonna just move away.
Oh, okay. How? So
I think actually, you both would get up to. Yeah, go for it.
Go on, Rodney. You've probably got a better initiative than I have, so yeah, you can go first. Roll your attack of opportunity.
Wait, I need to sort it, don't I? Oh yeah, attack of opportunity.
Does it matter what I use?
No, to be fair. Okay. No, you can't use a spell. It has to be a weapon. But yeah, you're a ranger, so I don't think you have any spells. And she would have been in melee range when you made the opportunity attack, so you can't use a longbow. You'll have to use a melee weapon. Well, you can use a longbow, but it'll be a disadvantage.
Okay. Can I use the short sword plus one?
Of course you can.
Then I shall pull that out and take a swing.
Yeah, we like that.
That will check.
Roll for damage.
Oh, let's say 6.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okie dokie. Skylar, that your turn over.
Yes, it is right now.
Okay, sweeper.
Rooney's going to use his reaction, not for the attack. He's going to use it for Stone Rune.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Sorry.
That's all right.
Make
a DC 14 wisdom save. Please fail. Hold on. Come on.
17.
Okay.
I've never rolled so good before, guys.
We know.
She's been looking forward to being this evil all day.
Not to self. Need to play more evil characters. Roll better.
Yeah, that's magic missile. These are going to hit you.
Yep.
Is that everything from you, Nikki? I can't hear you, but from you anything by your way, if you're saying anything.
I was hiding again.
Yeah.
Just trying to hide again.
I'm fair enough. That was not such a good stealth roll. So I think you're probably going to be seen. What's your passive perception, Nat?
12.
Yeah. You are not hidden, I'm afraid. No, you can't go and try again.
No.
Okay, Glyn.
Hello. I'm going to use my bonus action to blast Skylar again.
Yep.
Okay.
It's a constitution save.
What's the DC?
Yep.
Yes, it has one.
I definitely failed that. That was a 3.
14.
Yeah. 14.
That's 14.
3.
14. Sorry, say again?
That's 3 points of damage.
Okay.
And you're blind until the start of my next turn.
Ooh, fun.
Okay, is that it from you, Glenn?
That's my bonus action, so I'm
aware. Oh, that's your bonus action, yeah.
We hit with an axe.
22 to hit.
That hits.
For 14 damage.
Okay.
Okay, and is that it?
Yeah, that's the end of my turn.
That's it, fair enough. I know the picture here shows Benji, but this is now Rodney. Rodney?
Okay, okay. I'm going to straight away heal Rooney with Cure Wound.
Go for it.
Six. Take that. Yeah, I've been wondering where Delboy is.
We're getting there. John said he wanted his character to be called Rodney, and I just could not resist the rest of the jokes.
Right. So let me see. I think that's pretty much all I can do at this point.
All you can do for a minute. That's fair enough. I'm sure that'll make you popular.
It will.
I already like out the hole than... and rubbed up the Rooney.
Yeah, I already like you more than Benji.
Yeah.
To be fair, Rodney's with you. His most hated enemy is orcs.
Wow.
No. Rooney's gonna lollop over.
Yeah.
And then try and hit Illyria, ignoring the fact that she's actually Skylar. Doesn't care.
That hits.
Let's roll some damage. So 9. Okay. And then... Ooh, can you make a DC 14 strength save?
Yep. Can try. That's a 9.
Oh, okay. So you don't take 4 fire damage. So I'm pretty sure you're resistant to fire.
Yes, I am, because I'm still technically still fighting acid.
Yeah, technically still one. Oh, interesting. Okay. And then I've got to remember what it actually does. So you are now surrounded by fiery shackles, and you were restrained for a minute.
So this turn she's restrained and blind.
Yeah, please. And she can make a say at the end. At the end of your turn. Yeah.
Okay.
Does restrain mean can't do anything, reach for anything, or anything like that?
If I'm restrained.
D&D restrained. That's a good question.
Yes. I should have been doing that rather than just asking.
No, it's fine.
I'm the DM. I don't know what I'm doing.
Speed is zero, definitely. I know that much.
Yeah. That's fine.
So you can't move.
Restrained. I sort of feel like Skylar's got something up her sleeve.
All attack rolls against the creature have advantage. You have disadvantage on your attack rolls, and you have disadvantage on dexterity saving throws.
But nothing about any of the miscellaneous actions.
No.
Yeah. Awesome.
Just curious.
Yeah, just
okay. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Great. That's my turn.
Okay, yep, Skylar here.
Okay, so I'm restrained, I'm blind. Can't really do much right now. So she's going to stand there and let me just check if I can do that. Can do that, but I'm not going to. I'm going to glance around at the room, even though I can't actually see anybody, and just say that I can't wait to see you guys at the solar eclipse in a few days. It's going to be a good night. And I reach into my pocket. I find the other bean. I eat the bean. Skylar is gone.
He has, with a puff of smoke. She's disappeared from the room, and you're out of initiative.
Really, really wanted to kill her. Really.
You'll have your chance, don't worry.
Mm-hmm.
Really.
It's not tonight.
Oh, when I disappeared, a note dropped on the floor. So that, you know, just in case anybody wants to look at it.
Does this mean in the future we're going to have a one shot when Natasha comes back to play the big bad evil guy?
Guest appearance.
Okay. It's a possibility. Maybe.
Halloween special.
Yep.
With a resurrected Benji.
Yeah. He's actually going to be my servant now. He's just going to be like a zombie creature.
What do you want to do with Benji's body? I mean, he's just like, his heart's been ripped out and he's just laying on the floor right now.
To be honest, Rodney's just going to kick him and walk away.
Oh, fair enough. Well,
drag him and put him in the hole.
As you do that, little displaced beast kitten comes trotting out from the side and just sits on top of Benji's emaciated body and starts like mewling and pawing at him and making hissing noises at anybody that comes close.
Aww.
Yeah, you did that. You feel bad. You made the kitten sad.
I know Benji had to save the kitten, but was that a quest for everybody or just for Benji?
Everybody. So, if you convince Will to send the kitten back, yeah. I mean, there's no real reward. Actually, there was a reward for it, wasn't there? I think, but you actually have to get back to the carnival to collect it.
So can I actually do something a little bit spicy here and speak with animals?
You can, if you've got that spell. Of course you can.
Should I do?
Now I have to pretend to be a displaced beast kitten.
Oh. I've really tried to pet the cat.
Shoot, what you... the displaced beast kitten, because it's a displaced beast, appears... Where you try and pet something that isn't there, and while you're trying to pet something that isn't there, it bites your arm.
So I've just touched up a corpse instead. There was a cat there. I wasn't. It's not weird. It was the cat.
I do not want to know what you were betting.
You sort of see the last bit of life drain out of Benji as he winks at you.
Well, you know what they say happens to the male body after death.
Yeah,
Rooney comes and touches out.
Yeah. Old ladies, dead bodies. That's all I'm saying.
You would want to rearranging a peg collection in a bedroom before.
I was, yeah.
Didn't expect to be using the Fallen Heroes channel tonight.
Sorry, so what are you doing with Speak with Animals?
Yes, I'm just going to sort of talk to the young cat and find out what the connection is to the giant oaf laying on the floor. Yeah, and just trying to find some of its background, I guess.
Benji showed me kindness when I was lost in the wild. He drew me to Will, and he said he would go and find my mother. That's why I gave him my favorite. That's why he was here when he was here in the Feywild. He said he would go and find my mum and to stay safe with Will while I was gone. Well, he was gone.
Right. So I'm gonna now turn to the group and ask if they know anything of this cat and Benji's sort of friendship with said cat.
I mean, I didn't like Benji.
Oh, nobody did.
But I mean, he tried to drown me. But we did kind of promise to take the cat back to its mother, I think.
Okay.
This mother lives in a circus in the Lost and Found, I think.
Okay, okay. I mean, so I'm gonna turn back to the space circuit and just say, well, if you want to, you're welcome to travel alongside us. And we will try and get you back to the carnival with your mother.
I've made a deal with Will. If you rescue all the other children from here, I will go back. Otherwise, I'm by his side.
Okay, okay. So I'll explain the situation to the others and see where they stand on the Will situation.
I mean, turning the key or really annoying her, I think that maybe we agreed to kill Will or catch Will or do something to Will.
You agreed to catch Will. Unfortunately, we don't have Notes Lady with us anymore.
But we did definitely threaten to kill Will.
Just have the whisper of the leering in your head going, we said that we would try and capture him for the witch lady that you really like.
What you know is the witch is not going to try and kill Will. She just wants him captured because of the trouble he's causing in order to get good Steve back, who Sowpig still has. But of course, you don't have to do that, and that doesn't sound wonderful. I mean, also, at this point, Squirt the Oil Can, who's been hanging around Rooney as he does, goes, "Hidey-ho, Rooney!
Why are you still here? I mean, I ring that thing out to you. Surely that's all you wanted. Why just leave me?"
That is what I wanted, but I said I'd take you all with me to Yarn. And, well, it just strikes me that now is as good a time as any to get the fuck out of here.
Chicken?
See, I used one.
Yeah.
Damn it, I didn't get to use it.
What about Will and the cat and the... I mean...
Well... There's plenty around here to fight and steal. There's plenty around here to explore. It's entirely your choice. There is Will. There is the Displacer Kitten.
So yeah, can I pick up that note? This?
Not yet. No, you've all just completely ignored this fallen note on the floor so far.
Yeah. Go on then. Go on. Go get the note from the evil witch.
It is written in Sylvan, so I think
I can read it.
You can read it. The note says, "My darling Skylar, returned is what I had to borrow. Use it now to get what once belonged to the unicorn, for the event is in but 3 days to on the morrow. Then eat a bean, and to me you will be born. Hugs and kisses, Endelin."
Oh, hugs and kisses. Did you have to read that bit out loud?
I mean, that's what she can read. If she decides to read it out loud again, she can.
Yeah, I probably would have done that out loud.
Can't keep anything a secret. just a loudmouth Aarakocra. They repeat everything.
What?
What? Huh? Right. Yeah, I'm definitely for getting out of here. I mean, can we come back this way? Like, can we come back and make these things right?
You can, but there is still the matter of Steve to take care of.
What about Steve?
He's still trapped. It depends whether you want Steve or not.
You say, do we actually care?
So you remember the person that had Steve is just killed the green one?
Do you want to make me a investigation check or yeah, investigation?
Is that anybody or?
That is anybody who has met Steve. So I guess that's not you, Rodney. Sorry.
Okay. This is gonna go well. Oh. Great roll. The worst thing is,
Rooney is up for just eating any lizard that he finds. At
yeah, he's not interested.
With my plus zero, I got a 19.
Nice. With whenever you came into contact with Steve, you always felt he was perfectly genuine and not in any way evil, in any way, shape or form, and did really love banging those little symbols together, even though that wasn't him. That I've just remembered.
Yeah.
But you get the impression that if it was him, he would have really loved banging those little symbols together and be wearing the clothes that Nikki picked out for him.
I mean, I've got to admit, I kind of feel sorry for Sweeper at this point. She's lost Benji and Illyria in the space of like 10 minutes.
Tell you what, should we call a slightly early break?
Yeah.
Come back at 1:45. Well, you kind of have a think about what you want to do, because there's loads of stuff still to do around here, but because you have filled Squirt up, you can always head off if you want to. So, have a think, and then what we'll do is we'll sort of just, like, pick up the campaign where we left off. And there is the thing with the paintings, that's a good point. I would advise you to stick around here, but have a think. Does that sound good to everybody?
Yeah.
Okay, so we will come back at 1:45.
Okie dokie.
Cool.
Now.
That was dramatic.
I did not see that coming.
Me and Dom have literally been planning that all day.
Oh, gosh.
I think the best bit was me going, and this is where she turns evil and kills Benji.
Yep, exactly.
I mean, I must admit, at the back of my mind, I was like, the two of them have never actually even had a conversation. So why should suddenly invite me out for a coffee is beyond me. But being an orc and slightly dumb, I was like, okay, just run with it.
I just knew that, so when I spoke to Dom about it, I just knew that I had to get you into that room because it's a bigger space, so there's more. I think if we'd have all fought in that tiny room, it would have been a bit, like, it would have been too close combat. So that room just gave a little bit more. It was quite fun being evil for a little bit.
Must admit, it kind of hit me in the feels a little bit. It's the first actual character death I've had.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I've touched wood. I've experienced another character death. I've not experienced my own character death yet.
Don't worry, you'll get used to it.
Yeah.
32 years of playing, you'll get used to it.
Because I like the concept of Benji, but I was just struggling to do the orc druid mixture. Yeah. And it was starting to sort of, for me personally, it was starting to make it quite sort of unenjoyable.
Yeah.
Because I was just always like looking at the notes, like, what the hell am I supposed to do with this?
Well, I got a message from Dom about 2 days ago, and he's like, I've thought of how you can, like, how you can exit. But Benji also wants to be killed off at some point. He knows that someone's going to betray him, but doesn't know who.
I didn't actually know anyone was going to betray me. I just assumed it would be something like some fight broke out and I got caught in a crossfire.
We were trying to think of a really creative way of like just taking you out in one hit. And I think there was talk of a poison dagger. There was talk of a really powerful eldritch blast. Like there was so many different options. I was like, I kind of like the idea of like actually reaching into his chest and ripping his heart out. That sounds really cool.
Oh, dear.
I got my hair done today, so I was literally just sat in the hairdressers just talking to Dom all day.
Oh, God. I love that. Plotting someone to murder for like 9 hours.
Yeah. But it's also sad to see Illyria go as well, because she was a fun character.
This is my emotional support blanket.
I'm sorry, Nikki.
Well, to be fair, I'd sort of like Nikki to take over with the character, like with the character of Steve.
That was the plan. So when me and Dom talked about it, I think out of everybody, Steve would run to Sweeper.
Yeah.
If you guys decide to take him, of course, like there's no, you don't have to take him.
I mean, I must admit, I was kind of hoping to take the displacer cat as my own.
Yeah. We can all have animals.
Yeah, I've got a Rooney.
Yeah.
I just cried off screen.
Oh, no. Blame Dom. Dom is the evil genius. I just went with it.
It's
more genius on both of us, to be fair.
In fairness, I was just a victim.
Yeah.
But it was only sort of when I quickly looked at my character sheet between Benji dying and Rodney entering, I realised like Rodney absolutely hates orcs. So seeing Benji dead has been like the highlight of his day.
Yeah. Nikki, are you okay?
No.
Oh.
I'm guessing that you didn't know when this was coming.
I'm not okay. I am not okay.
Oh, no.
You can tell you just had the Iron Brew open.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah, literally, me and Dom were the only ones that knew about this.
I mean, I obviously knew that Benji was going, but I just didn't know how or what was going to happen.
If it helps, I found it funny.
I did the Kalimar thing.
Yeah, you sort of went sort of partially Vecna.
I really don't like Endolin now.
And that's the best thing, because Kyla is, Dom has thought of everything with this, because she is part of the campaign further on with Endolin, there is a chance that if it gets to that point, I could come back for that, just to, you know, be evil.
Yeah, I definitely think we...
Double twist, come back later on and turn to the other side.
Yeah. I come back as Steve in a few weeks.
Oh, I just had a funny image. I know there's like this race, like lizard folk, like it's a playable race, but what if like Steve like came back as like a full fledged party member?
Yep. He's there. If anybody wants to use him, he's there. Yeah, Dom is the evil genius behind all of it.
To be fair, I think we should just ignore Steve and just keep evil Steve, because he's better anyway.
Yeah. But I don't think we've ever really met normal Steve.
You kind of did in the carnival, for a day when he had unicorn makeup on him. That was about it.
So what sort of surprises me is Evil Steve jumped head first into the drug cake.
Yeah.
Even though he knew it was obviously drugged.
Yeah. I didn't even know there was going to be an Evil Steve.
I mean, he's evil. He's probably
a madman.
Probably loves drugs. Sorry. Evil.
Technically, Evil Steve wouldn't have known the cake was drugged because he was Evil Steve belonging to Scabatha rather than anything to do with the Bullywugs or... Yeah. But was that all right?
Yeah.
You
scarred me.
I was going to say, ask Nicky.
What, how did I scar you with the kitten? I thought I'd just get that little dig in there.
I've been her emotional support blanket.
Oh, yeah, I've scarred Nicky. Oh, excellent. That wasn't
was
my
that you're the evil genius behind all of this, but we've been talking for like the last, like, pretty much the entire day trying to get this sorted out.
Yeah, so well, I gave you three options. I gave you a nice, happy. I gave one where you could go and try and save the Feywild and just disappear. I gave you another option where you could go down fighting. But
no, you I wouldn't kill pick... Benji.
Yeah, I already knew that you would pick the evil option. One second.
But I also sort of see it as a kind of fitting exit for Benji as well.
Yeah, well, that's the thing. You said... Because Well, to be honest, I said to you, are you sure you want to keep him? And you were like, no, I really want to get rid of him. So I told you you were going to get murdered, but I didn't tell you the how, why, or who, did I?
Yeah, no. I just assumed it would be like some sort of fight, and I got caught in the crossfire.
Yeah.
It was literally... Just like a misplaced firebolt or something.
Mm. Yeah. So you had your heart ripped out and you were left twitching on the floor.
Mm. I was thinking as well about how Tom had come up with other ideas, like a poison dagger, or like there was a few other ideas floating around, but I was like, no, I want to physically like reach into his chest and rip his heart out.
Yeah. I did actually come up with like an unarmed weapon for it as well, but we didn't get that. You just did it. It's fine. Yeah. It's all good. Yeah.
I mean, to be fair, I did eat the bean, and then I did do the...
Oh, yeah, no, that's fine. Yeah, but I kind of...
just didn't do it.
I wanted people to be involved at the same time. I didn't want to feel like the rest of you were just sort of watching a story that you couldn't do anything about, if that makes sense.
I really thought I was going to get to kill her.
Mm. See, here's the thing now, because I know sort of what Nick is probably thinking of, was there a way of potentially saving Benji before that happened?
No.
I thought of quite a few ways, but none of you had the abilities to do it. I spoke with a couple of people about maybe if somebody was close, you could do silvery barbs or something, but it never got to an attack. And if it got to an attack, the only person that could have cast shield on you to put your AC up was the person trying to rip your heart out.
technically, if I'd known what was happening, I could have used bark skin and raised my armor class.
You could. So it's a good job you didn't know what was going to happen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I want to point out, Skylar does have the unicorn horn as well.
Yeah.
So you guys are going to have to get that back.
She does, but there are other ways.
Can I suggest the group actually loot Benji's body because there are some pipes of haunting?
Mm. Well, that's a good point. You do have the pipes of haunting.
Mm. And then I've got like a monocle and a few other silly bits.
We'll let Rodney can take them. Rodney can dig through your body.
Let's say Rodney gets your trinkets, your random trinkets, and well, it's up to you about the pipes of haunting. You can have the pipes of haunting. Rodney can have the pipes of haunting. They can have fallen off Benji's body and down the grates into the cell, and he could have come up holding them.
Just before we head back, because I'm going to shoot now, because otherwise I'm literally going to be sat here doing nothing for like an hour and 15 minutes.
Sorry, I thought it might take a little bit longer than this. I guess I did whip through that first combat a lot sooner than I thought I was going to, but an hour.
These guys get to have more fun.
There's reverse time by an hour.
I didn't want to get past 11 where you said, I've really got to go.
Just before everybody like shoots back on, I just wanted to say thank you guys so much. I've had so much fun playing with you all, and I've learned so much from playing.
Yeah, thank you.
And I do hope to come back at some point.
Mm. I've left the door open for if you want to come back and beat these guys' asses into the ground again.
Yes.
I'll let you know the session.
Because if it wasn't for the fact that you guys had like blended me and grappled me at the same time, I was still going to keep going because I wasn't near death at that point.
Slightly overpower Skylar. slightly. So next time when you do have a fight, anybody can die.
Yep.
Basically.
I aim to kill.
Yeah. There'll be no get outs, no magic beans, no nothing.
Yeah.
Mm.
Natasha.
Yeah.
You were saying in something that you were looking at running a game.
Yes, I was looking
maybe
at
a home game or something.
Yeah, I was looking at a one shot at some point.
I think I said, I don't know if you caught it, I've done a lot of GMing and alpha testing and beta testing in the past. So if you need any advice, just ask.
Oh, well, thank you. I really appreciate it, guys.
We're going to have
I will definitely be putting all of your brains on play because you guys have done this longer than a lot longer than I've done it. What was that, John?
Halloween special.
Halloween special where sort of maybe potentially Benji comes back from the dead and is used against the team.
I'll make you do the thriller dance.
Yes. Awesome. Right, guys, enjoy. And
thank you.
Please look out for Steve.
I'll kill him. It's fine.
Thanks, guys. I'll see you later. Yeah,
bye. Right. Yeah. Bye, Nikki. Bye.
Nikki's sad now.
Sorry.
It's a double loss.
Yeah.
Or a double win? No.
Yeah.
If
Bench is dead.
Did you see any of it coming, Nikki?
See, if you are in any of my games, I am. It's on.
Oh, the dog's gonna get it.
Yeah, that's fair enough. I think next game I'm playing, you're in it. So yeah, you got to be a little bit nice to me.
I think I'm in that one as well, aren't I?
You are, yes. You, Crow, and Nikki are the only ones confirmed at the minute, unless anybody else has shot up. So tomorrow morning when I get up, I'm going to put a call out for the last two places. Because I think there were a couple of people that said they would play, but they've not. You know, I've given them like 48 hours now and they've not said anything, so.
I was more sort of meaning when, if I'm ever in the DM chair.
Oh, yeah, I know what you meant. Yes, I don't think I've played in a game that you've DM'd yet, so I will have to do that. Where's the other one you're doing? Is it the week after Wednesday the 14th? Is that full now?
Is that the one that I'm running for Baldrick?
Oh, no, I've got my in-person game that day. That's why I couldn't do that one. Yeah. Yes, because I was going to run one for a week on Sunday, but yes, for reasons. Well, we're not on stream right now. Don't put us on stream. Don't put us live yet, Nikki, because I just want to tell people what an absolute idiot I can be. Nobody can hear us right now on the stream, can they?
Oh, let me turn this.
Yes.
I think they can hear us.
Oh,
okay, fair enough. Right, I won't say anything then.
I can temporarily turn the sound off so nothing is heard if.
Yeah, go on, because people find it funny.
Okay. It's off.
Okay, so I arranged this game because Gordon was saying it didn't get much chance to play, so I said, right, well, when can you do a game? He said Sunday, so I can't do this Sunday, it's too short, so next Sunday. He said, fair enough. And then I've got this one shot.
Testing sound. 1, 2. Sound someone else speak.
3, 4.
No.
Oh, ruined it.
Yes, sounds back.
Excellent. Right.
Are
we live?
We're back live.
Okay, so after all those scenes, you are now in this kitchen that I can try and give you a bit more information about. I can recap, but you do have Trigger here who's come out of hiding and goes, oh, you've let Dave out of his prison. Oh, I like Dave.
I've told you it's Rodney.
What's that, Dave?
I'm going to pull an axe and just walk towards him and sort of pin him to the wall and scream, my name is Rodney.
Oh, I quite like it when you pin me to the wall, Dave.
Right.
Because Only Fools and Horses slash fiction is exactly what everyone's tuned in for tonight.
Yeah. Right, when you two finished over there...
This is why we need another girl, Nikki. When you're doing a shout-out for Illyria's replacement. Because otherwise we've just got very immature men.
excuse me.
Yeah.
That's very, very immature, thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah, when you finish your foreplay, Trigger and Dave, do you want to clean the body up into the hole and search his pockets first?
Yeah, oh, he's got some trinkets. Do you want those, Dave?
Yeah, I'm gonna loot his carcass. But what I'll do off stream is I'll add the items into the inventory.
Yeah.
And then we're just gonna pull Benji and chuck him into the hole.
Yeah.
Can I take his gold? Can I take his gold and stuff as well? Or
yes, of course you can.
We haven't found anywhere to spend gold. I don't know why you're taking that, but
no, there isn't anywhere to spend gold. Gold, but... there are no shops.
I'm gonna release the kid.
To be fair, Benji was loaded for some unknown reason.
You're gonna release the kitten?
Kid.
Mm. Oh, the kid.
There was a kid chained to the workstation.
There was?
Yeah, Trigger goes, well, you seem to have bested that scary lady, so I'll unhook her and I'll make a suggestion. If you could possibly convince Will to go with you, be captured, he might think of a way to distract Granny Nightshade while you get away with the rest of the kids. My suggestion here would be if you could get those keys off her, you could unlock some of the doors. And they could get you a way out of here.
We've already got one key.
I mean, can Sweeper not just unlock the doors?
Yeah, unfortunately, the key you've got actually just unlocked the door to this room, which was already unlocked because that kid was trying to steal food.
That's just really not helpful.
But I know Scabatha has a key ring on her.
I mean, the last time I tried to touch her... He got quite physical quite quickly.
Well, just play nice.
We've got a sweeper. Can't sweeper just unlock the doors for us?
She could have a
As far as I know, these are magical doors that will only be opened with the specific key.
Trigger, what help are you?
Do you know? Well, I'm giving you some fairly helpful guidance here.
You're telling us a lot of things we can't do. Do you know where there's a painting?
I do. I do know where there's a painting. Just bear with me while I rack my brains.
Behind
clean
that locked
door. Clean is going to go everywhere.
Can Benji, not Benji, can Rodney snap his broom and go, now you need a new one?
I never need a new broom. I've had the same broom for 30 years.
This one just gets a new handle.
Yeah, just going to get it a new handle.
And a new head.
I know. I only got it a new head the other week. Yeah.
Had the same broom for 30 years. And you only had 9 new handles and 12 new heads.
That's... He goes, oh, I've just remembered. Just directly through that door that you came through before you went and had a sleep in that lady's bedroom, and then all the weird, scary stuff happened. Go and have a peeksy in there.
Don't need to be asked twice.
Yeah, because I can't do a Cockney accent. So
you were going West Country then, weren't you?
Trigger's gone West Country because I can do a bit of a West Country accent, but I can't do Cockney. No, that's not even close.
All of a sudden, Trigger's from Salisbury.
Yeah. Right, Trigger, where are you? You sent us in here, up the stairs?
Just bear with me. Let's get everyone together. Are you done now, or do you want me to come with you and like describe things as we go along?
Oh, definitely. You can definitely be the guide. Come on, Trigger.
Fair enough, then.
You did no help in that fight.
Yeah. Well, as you can see here, ladies and gentlemen, this room has three doors and a wood-carved staircase that ascends to a higher level. The walls are a dense tangle of roots and brambles, nestled among which are five animated portraits, one of a svelte, dark-haired woman and the others depicting hags.
Is this the
Just...
queen and the three hags?
Hmm. So Word just... you like.
Just to interrupt, am I still playing with Benji's dead token at the moment, or...?
Where's Benji's? Oh, great! I thought I gave you access to Rodney.
No.
No, you do. You should have access to Rodney. Can you see anything with Rodney? Hang on, mate. Ah, I didn't turn his vision on. There we go. Right. I'm going to delete Benji. I know. That's it now. That's it. That's the final moment.
Benji. Yay.
Can you now move Rodney?
Yeah, I can.
Excellent. So if you take a closer look at the pictures, you can see a picture of a truly ancient and terrifying hag. You can also see a toadish hag, a skeletal hag wearing a black theatrical contraption resembling a dress, and a hag with a wind-up key in her back, one empty eye socket, and a wooden eye held in her hand. And you also see a svelte, dark-haired woman with a commanding presence. Would somebody like to make me a history check?
Don't
anybody, to be fair.
I don't feel like that should be a Rooney.
Rodney walks in. He's just like, hey, I know that woman. That's Tasha.
My ex-wife.
Tasha, as in Tasha's hideous laughter.
Tasha's hideous laughter, who, when Rodney says that, the rest of you remember that outside that tent where two halflings got into a little bit of a spat, it was because the statue told a hideous laughter joke. That is Tasha, as in Tasha's cauldron.
Oh dear. I'm suddenly liking this journey less and less, but can anyone remember which picture we're supposed to be getting?
It's a picture of Scabatha, isn't it?
It's a picture of Scabatha, yeah. So you want the one of the lady with the wind-up key.
Though technically I wouldn't know this as of yet.
Although technically you wouldn't know that. But
no. So
we'll roll with it, you're fine.
Up close and personal with Scabatha.
Yeah.
Very personal, from what I've heard.
So, I mean, Aruni, obviously you know that the picture of her, if you would like to reach up and grab it, I'm afraid you're going to need to make me a dexterity saving throw.
Not going to end badly at all. I mean, this is just because I'm short. It's a bit harsh. Yep. So good.
Yeah. Unfortunately, as you reach up to get the picture, one of the thorns that wrap around the portraits pricks your finger. And the biggest portrait changes to look like you. Now, I don't know too much about Aruni's background, but the rest of the pictures will now all change to be members of your family.
Okay. So you just see a lot of dwarfs that you can't tell if they're men or women. Just a lot of beards, a lot of grey hair.
But Rooney's quite shocked. He goes, Mum!
Mum? Even I can't tell. Right. Well, that's not helpful. So all the pictures have changed.
They have, I'm afraid.
That's not helpful. So now we need to prick Scabatha with a thorn.
If you want to get the picture.
Or can we just take all of them?
You can try and take all of them, but anybody who's going to grab one will need to make me a DC 15 dexterity saving throw.
Come on, Aracocra, fly up there and get it. Make yourself useful.
I'll try.
First feel like this has got you written all over it, or Rodney.
Well, as Glint reaches up and grabs one, everybody changes to, like, the big one changes to Glint.
It's not like a trap save, is it?
No, why?
Because I get advantage on deck saves versus, like, traps and spells and shit that I can see.
I mean, you can have advantage if you want. There's really no reason why you shouldn't. Okay. When you reach up and get the picture, because you rolled after Aruni, you get a picture of Aruni's second cousin, Bryony.
It's a really bad picture.
I'll show Aruni. I was like, hey, Aruni, is this your niece, nephew?
Dad.
Dad,
just insulting. Dad. Yeah. No, I'm joking. It's my cousin. She's ugly for a dwarf.
Yeah.
But
as Rodney then also reaches up and takes a picture, the picture you've got in your hand changes, because the big pictures change up to look like Rodney, and the rest look like Rodney's family, and then when Sweeper reaches up and tries to grab one, it pricks her, and the big picture is of Sweeper, and the rest of the clutch, I suppose.
Just one is an egg. Just
yeah. So now you've got a group of pictures of birds.
Right. So now, correct me if I'm wrong, and in fairness, I probably need to do an intelligence check for Aruni. Probably not.
Here's a question: mm-hmm. Are these fae nesting pictures?
Are they what? Sorry.
Fae nesting pictures. So like Russian nesting dolls. Taking the piss because it's an Arakocra.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, sorry. I was really lost for a second then. I thought it was an actual thing. Sorry, my bad.
That's right. I think even Aruni might work this out. He's like, right, so the hags, Tasha is related to them?
As far as you can tell with that intelligence save, yeah.
That's... I don't know if that's weird or comforting. I mean, she's pretty powerful, I think. They write books about her. Oh, her cauldron's powerful anyway. I don't know about her, actually.
I mean, she's no Baba Yaga.
Who did what?
Well, if you remember, the big picture when you walked in here was of Baba Yaga.
I mean, that's not funny.
Oh, no, sorry. I didn't say that.
No.
The big picture when you walked here was in a truly ancient and terrifying hag.
You did.
So and that was my mother-in-law, that was.
Is that why you were in the hole in the floor?
Yeah, I was hiding for my own safety.
See that? I know what Scabatha did to me.
What happens in Vegas stays in Vegas.
Right, so we have a picture, but it's not the right picture. Can Aruni break off one of the thorns?
Well, the big question is, was it the actual portrait she wanted, or...
It's just the fact that it changes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Who knows? We'll take it anyway, but could I break off one of the thorns?
You can. By all means.
Can I stab Rodney with it?
Yeah, of course. All the pictures change back to pictures of Rodney.
Ah, it doesn't even need to be attached to the tree.
Oh, you...
Good to know.
No, it doesn't need to be attached to the tree.
Good. Okay. Take a thorn.
Mm.
So we in this... take off paintings. Because then we give her the paintings and the thorn and she can make them whoever she wants.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and we've got loads of... We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pictures. Mm. Take them all. I mean, somebody's got to carry them. That's going to be the problem. Well volunteered, Glint.
God damn it.
That's right. I'm not really doing encumbrance, so no.
I'm gonna go into the kitchen, look for a big sack, like an old potato sack or something.
Yeah, you can do a solid snake and just like have literally everything in the world. You can have a rocket propelled grenade launcher next to.
Right. Now we need to get back to Will.
Anyway,
out of all that I just heard, we can have a rocket propelled grenade launcher.
No, you can't have a rocket propelled grenade launcher.
Oil
just stores. Before you go that way, I just want to say that this door here, come back a bit. There we go.
Calling to me.
is magically locked. There is an upstairs. If you want to go and have a look
Trigger,
upstairs.
What's upstairs?
Just bear with me while I rack my brains.
The worst cleaner in the world. You just wander around not paying attention to anything.
I just clean up the floor. I don't look up.
Rodney's going to shake his head and be like, worst tour guide ever.
If I remember rightly, there's three large freestanding looms that dominate that chamber, and a young goblin and a pair of gnome children work the machines, filling the room with a loud rhythmic clatter. A door is set in the opposite wall, and an archway leads to the storeroom.
Well, look, we've got to go. Let's go now.
And Zachary wants to kill a goblin.
I might have to drag you up there. It's one of these things where it sort of zooms to another area.
Oh, yeah,
right.
Any excuse.
No. Just gather yourselves together.
Circle up.
I mean, Rodney doesn't really understand what's happening, so he's just sort of standing around, looking at the floor.
Rodney, we should probably introduce you to this. If we have something we're supposed to do, we just tend to not do it.
Yeah. Right, I think I've just dumped you in, like, a random area there, so just... Yeah, you go, that'll do.
See looms.
So you come out here, so there are some children working. If you want to loot the room, there is stuff to loot.
I mean, I feel a bit bad now. Normally,
if you want to speak to the poor children, you're welcome to speak to the poor children.
Oh, I don't want to speak to the children. Let's loot the room.
Yeah. There's some miserable children, so there may be some more boggles around.
Oh, I did like ringing that boggle. Let's look.
That sounded so inappropriate.
I got to squeeze it until all the liquid came out.
I mean, to be honest, out of game here, most of the children stuff that can tell you, you already sort of know because I dragged you, well, me and Nat dragged you all the way to the, back and, yeah, and then you've come back the other way. So if you want to root around here, you can find a gold bodkin, a pouch holding 35 silver pieces, and a small leather-bound book containing delicate sketches and watercolour paintings of pixie sprites and other fae that's worth 50 gold pieces.
Where's the shiny kleptomaniac when you need one?
No, you can just find those. You can just root round. You don't need to actually steal
them.
No
way we'd get to keep them if the kleptomaniac was around. Sweeper.
Oh, yeah.
Do you like shiny things? You're pretty much a Lyria now. You shoot fire and...
Yeah. I think he's been very quiet.
What?
I think we've broken her.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sorry, Nicky.
We're just handing you coins and watercolour pictures.
Cool.
So, like, Rodney's going to turn to Rooney and go, so... Who does the canary belong to?
Excuse me?
I mean, you don't need to talk to animals to know that was not great for you.
He says with a smile on his face.
She belongs to Glint. He looks after her. Nothing to do with me.
Well, Rodney's just going to turn and sort of wave at Sweeper.
Hi.
Right, let's go and get some plot done. I'm dragging you back. Badly.
Upstairs.
Because there really isn't anything interesting up there. You're back. Well, I'll put you back in the kitchen, but I'll put you back. In that.
We need to go find Will. So if you remember,
you got to go past the keep going down the corridor, and then it's here. You probably can't see where I'm pinging. I'll lead you
to this room.
He was going to be out of here.
He was indeed. There's my boggle friend. Come on, Rodney, keep up. In fact, Glint might need dragging because he's not here, Dom.
Oh, is he? Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Nicky's got the
hiccups. I'm still having severe issues with roll 20.
Cool. Let's jump out the window.
Yeah.
Or door.
That door is open. Oh, you can go out that way. Bring it up. So you see Will here in the hedges, about to try and climb in the tree. But just to describe the area, a woodland basin filled with plants and fungi stretches out along one side of the fallen tree. A pumpkin patches at one end of the garden next to a steaming compost heap, with ramshackle pens for pigs and goats at the opposite end. Bedraggled scarecrows hang from tall wooden stakes in the basin's wooded slope. Two ground-level doors and three balconies provide entry to the hag's lair. But you already know how to get in and out there, so that bit wasn't important. So Will's there, and Will's like, "What are you doing out here? You were supposed to distract her while I creep in and get the children out."
Yep, so there was a big clockwork key in her back. And I...
Yes.
Kind of touched it.
Right. So she isn't very happy with you right now.
I think she killed me 3 times, nearly. Maybe.
Well, more. You're still standing, so that's always good. But is she distracted?
No. And then some people died, and then one of us turned evil. It's been a day.
It sounds like a day. So, is there a new plan? Because I was just going to bust in through this window and try and get the kids out. Is that still on the cards?
I don't think so.
I think we can get the kids out, but I think you might have to be the distraction.
What do you mean?
We need you to pretend to be captured.
Yes, pretend. Yes.
How do you plan to do that?
I mean, I'm pretty sure I've got some rope. We could kind of tie you up.
I better be able to get out of it.
I mean, I'm sure you're resourceful.
Oh, you have no idea.
I mean, you escaped once, right?
I wouldn't say escaped is quite the word for it. Do you want to make me a perception check, Aruni? Wow, is that your perception check?
That was for the room. Do a perception check now.
Oh, yeah.
It's not much better. 15?
No, that's pretty good. You can sort of tell that Will isn't actually a human child.
What are you?
Just bear with me so I don't actually say anything wrong.
Nobody in this place who they seem to be.
No, it's the Feywild, I'm afraid. Oh, why can I never find anything when I'm looking for it?
Will, why are you trying to remember what you are? You say, yeah, the plan is we'll just pretend to capture you. You can...
But I was somehow cursed in a good way. I was an evil creature that was cursed to be good, and now I've dedicated my life to saving all the children of the Feywild. I was an Oni.
Oni what?
Ah.
Well, I'm Oruni. That's close. Right, so you were really evil, and now you're not. Nothing in this place makes sense. We had a friend who was really nice, and now she's really evil.
Yeah, well, if I look at you, I thought you'd be really nice, and here we are.
Rodney's going to laugh on this exchange.
What part of me makes anybody think I'd be nice?
It's nothing. The beard. You look like a midget Santa.
Isn't that Santa? It's short anyway. Why does he think Santa's tall?
And there's something wrong with him.
Yeah. Anyway, so yeah, you can pretend to be caught. We'll get the keys to the kids, and then everybody can escape, right? That sounds like a plan that's well thought out.
I'll be up for that. That does sound like a plan. Worst comes to the worst. Well, whatever you do, don't cure my curse.
I mean, because then you'll turn into something really evil. How would we do that, by the way?
A simple remove curse spell would do it. But please don't, because then I become evil and I'll attack you.
I don't think any of us can do that.
Yeah, I think you're pretty safe.
Yeah. I think there was one of you who might have been able to do that. Where's she gone?
Yeah.
No, she's evil.
Turn bad.
Oh, yeah. It happened.
Without the green one's heart.
She kind of reminded me of a member of the League of Malevolence.
You say none of us can do that. Clint will take a couple of steps up, rubbing his hands together.
No, Clint, don't.
Well, I can't either, so.
No.
A little terrified Will in front of you.
Worth it every time.
Yeah. Right, let's go take you to Scabatha.
Okay.
I mean, pretend to.
Who's going to be the front man here? Because this is going to take a deception check. With advantage.
I'm a good liar.
Right, well, my deception's plus zero, so...
Yeah.
I'm going to leave that one alone.
So, Sweeper? Are you going to...
be me or Sweeper. I didn't hear
great at lying. I'm great at lying.
Yeah, lying down.
Yeah, he says while lying and being bad at it.
Just out of humour, I'm going to do the deception check with Rodney.
What are you lying about?
You thought you were bad.
Practices. I hope these are practices. Yeah, well, you're not there. You've not said anything yet to deceive, so you're not using any of these roles.
I did. I lied about being good at lying. Look.
Oh, yeah.
And I lied about
you're going terrible to the curses.
Definitely. Oh, are we letting Sweeper be in charge of this?
I trust the bird, or possibly this elf.
I mean, we don't know the elf. We just met him in a hole. I mean, in fairness.
Well, to be fair, you've seen the Feywild. It is all a hole at the minute.
From the sounds I heard, you're used to investigating holes yourself.
He was trying to pet the cat. I was trying to pet cat.
That wasn't the issue I was speaking about, young
really
man.
He's just walking away.
To be fair, the witch probably trusts her in you slightly more.
She does know that I'm going to try and kill her.
He doesn't like you.
Show her a good time.
Repeatedly. Right, come on, Will.
Yeah, if you all want to make your way back into the tea parlour.
I guess I'll pretend to escort Will in.
Yeah.
If you're pretending to escort Will in, you'll need to make a deception check when we get talking. You want to leave it all up to Sweeper, then she'll be the one with the ropes. Because that's going to be convincing, isn't it? A tiny little bird leading in the prisoner.
I mean,
I figure if Arena doesn't say anything, he might. He'll genuinely tie Will up. Yeah, I'll genuinely tie Will up.
Will you genuinely tie Will up or give him, make it loose so he can get out?
If Sweeper's leading him in with a rope,
tie Will up.
We can just be poking him with weapons so that he goes in.
Okay. I'll genuinely tie Will up and then cut it, hopefully.
Right. Make me a persuasion check.
Oh, that's not going to go well. What, to persuade Will?
That he's okay with you actually tying him up, yes.
I mean, no, you're trying to... And
then you can cut the ropes.
No.
No, I'm not going for this. I won't go with you. Okay, unless you make those bounds loose.
So what would happen if Rodney was to sort of push him to the floor, hog tie him, and then just throw him over his shoulder and start walking?
Contested strength check. If you want to do that, you can do.
No, Rodney, no. Oh.
I've not rolled yet.
So it'll be athletics.
New guy's going to get us into as many fights as Benji used to.
Yeah, good luck. Oh! You have good luck. You have pinned Will to the floor, hogtied him, and now you have him over your shoulder.
Yeah, but I am going to leave it loose enough that he can't escape.
Okay. Does he know this?
Yes. I'll tell him the plan of action as I'm tying him up.
All right, he's a bit depressed. He's like, no. this doesn't seem right, but fine, I'll go. I don't suppose I have much choice, do I?
Really?
Listen, Will.
I kind of want to slap him.
You want to slap Will?
Will or Rodney?
Hit him with a bag of wet sand. Knock him out.
This took a very dark turn.
Do you still have that bar of soap? You could put that in a sock.
I believe I do.
I'm just going to call out Will and get told.
Nicky, we're getting a girl next.
Dom, what is that film called with that military bloke where they batter him with the socks of bars of soap in?
Full Metal Jacket.
I was thinking South Park with the Nits episode, actually, but
I've
never seen Full Metal Jacket.
Corporal Pyle.
Right, Sweeper. No pressure. We've tied him up. You need to convince her. That this is real. Come on, Will.
Because Will is now kind of willing, because you have him hogtied over, you can do this with advantage, but it does have a high DC. What are you saying?
Saying, Sweet.
We captured Will like you told us to do. Here he is.
Excellent. Pass him over and then you can have your Stevie back.
Oh, Rodney's in the whispered Sweeper. I thought your feathers.
Okay, I'll puff my feathers up. That doesn't really do anything, but I'll do it anyway.
Come on. Hand him over.
I'll slide
Maybe
him over.
Maybe give him a kick as well.
We just got the new boy bringing him.
Out of character, if Rodney's carrying him over, shouldn't Sweeper be trying to steal the keys?
Yeah.
Okay. I was just making sure that we had that kind of plan. Because I wasn't here.
We're all going to walk towards her. And
Rooney, we don't want your plan.
my plan is to be distracting him, like, so about that key, and just walk behind him.
You'll just stay away. I've already heard about how you caused calamity and.
Why have you got a key?
Playing with my peg collection.
Oh, that did happen.
And why the key on your bed.
Yeah.
It's just part of me. Leave it be. And this key that it really just starts slowing down spinning because, as you know, the slower it spins, the angrier she gets.
Right. I don't think I can do much more to distract her sweeper.
We do still have time for a TPK tonight. We've still got half an hour.
I mean, we don't. I'll just leave.
I'm being as distracting as humanly possible.
Yeah.
Sleight of hand.
So have I still got the boy over my shoulder?
Yeah, but you're not into the room yet, so I think you need to...
I know, but he's having issues, so I can always bring him across.
Poor Will.
I don't even know where Rodney's gone now, to be fair.
Oh, I'm here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I had to rebooted Roll20.
Wait a sec, why is Sweeper doing the sleight of hand when my sleight of hand's better?
Oh, no, that was a terrible sleight of hand. She sort of bats your hand away and goes, "Get back!" and pushes you back 5 feet. Hand over the boy, and you'll get your lizard.
About the key, I did...
Can I sort of put the boy in the corner, like a corner far away from her? So his back is against the wall, so she can't see his hands?
He's with you, you can put him wherever you want. Is there anywhere you're going with this?
Yeah, basically, I'm going to put him his back to the wall so she can't see his hands, so he can start to free himself.
Okay. You've put the baby in the corner.
I'm going to pat him on the head and say, sit there, shut up.
Where's Steve? Let's see Steve. You can see Will. Where's Steve?
Fine. I'll bring Steve out.
And how do we know it's not evil Steve?
Because you still have evil Steve. Don't you?
Oh, yeah.
No, technically he was with Skylar when she vanished.
Ah, so I guess, I mean, who? What?
It's out of the bag. I mean, technically two cats are out of the bag.
Did we put the other cat in a bag?
We should have done.
While we're talking shit and she's probably getting confused at our conversation, I'm going to try and swipe the keys off of her.
Sow Pig will come and stand over in this corner, coming through this door, and hold open the box that holds Steve.
That's not any better.
No.
This is why
it was better, but it wasn't good enough, and this key is really turning down now. Give me the boy, and you can have your lizard. And she's going to you want to do a contested strength check? Because she's going to try and push you away. So, I'm going to need you to beat 21.
I think she should have beat me on this one.
You're not strong. No. 10.
You're a barbarian. I mean, you could make that athletics if you want, if that's going to make a difference.
It might.
If this goes wrong, can Rodney try and sort of calm the situation?
She's only trying to push her back. You can. How are you going to try and calm the situation?
With persuasion check, possibly? Just sort of...
Yes. No, you'll need to make a persuasion check. What would you like to say to try and calm the situation?
Just tell everyone sort of relax, calm down for a few minutes. And let's just start talking sense. She wants the boy. We apparently want this bizarre looking bug eyed lizard.
Do we really want the lizard? I mean, I just kind of wanted to touch the key. But I know if I touch the key, you're going to get mad at me again. Can I just touch it once?
Yeah, this is... No.
Just once. You didn't... Last time, you hit me on the floor like three or four times. You didn't let me touch the key.
Right.
Fine. Okay. If this will end it, you can touch it one time. You feel a metal key.
I think I have to be raging to get advantage on.
You're not. You can't steal the key.
I'm not trying to steal the key.
Is part of her.
Trying to steal her keys while touching the key.
A set of keys. That's what we were trying to.
Yeah.
Ah, got you. Okay, well, actually, yes, you beat the DC of 15. So, yeah, as you fondle the contraption in her back, you manage to sneak the set of keys off her belt.
Rodney's going to look at Rooney and said, you enjoyed that way more than you should have.
Yeah, I mean, that's just weird. I'm just going to back away now. Like, that's weird. It's weird that you've got a key in you.
As long as you're happy now.
I mean, I'm a bit freaked out, if I'm honest.
I mean, the that probably going makes her even happier.
Yeah.
The fact that she's managed to freak you out is probably a better.
The key is getting very dangerously slow to stopping.
Right, Will, can you just admit that you're captured?
Will goes, yeah, they've got me. They got me dead to rights.
We did what you've asked. He's there in the corner.
Rodney's going to whisper to Sweeper, kick him. Kick him.
Kick Will.
Scabbers, fine. Take your lizard and be gone. You are not welcome in Gloomchurch anymore. I'm not even going to give you the reward from the poster.
I mean, that's
for
just
all your actions.
Isn't that the reciprocity thing? Come on.
Fair enough. If you really want the reward from the poster, you may have the reward from the poster.
I remember what it was, but I feel like
you're about to.
I feel like it's against the rules to break.
Pressed it.
Many different rewards.
I think which was the one you got, Aruni? There was many different rewards, but I think was the one the strength of it. No, it wasn't.
Strength of an Aarakocra.
What did you have to do? Look at the poster.
Poster you found had a thingy on it. I will
refuse to do anything.
Let me just check my notes.
I'm pretty sure Rudy's refused to do anything.
See if I can remember what it was.
I think we've seen three different ones.
I really refused to look at any of them. Or look in the puddle. That's why Benji tried to drown him. Or eat cake.
You did, but you. I think you. I'm pretty certain you only brought one with you.
Who had one?
Quite possibly. I think Illyria picked it up. It was the one right outside of where we first met Will.
Yeah. I'm going to get Steve.
So, I can't remember. Could you roll me a d8, please, Aruni?
Why does Aruni have to do these things?
This is where he gets a natural 8 on the d8.
Actually, I think this might have been the one as well. The post you had says, "This little troublemaker belongs to me. Bring him home alive and unharmed, and you'll win the heart of the one you love."
I don't love anybody.
No, I think there was somebody that was missing their heart.
No, it's the one you love. Is there anybody special to you, Aruni?
If so, you now have their beating heart in your hand.
Yeah, in his backstory, absolutely not. He's like an orphan, so no. Join the army.
Is it to be fair, he's kind of been getting a bit fresh for a hag.
To be fair, the only thing you're doing that is just Clave.
I would say it's himself.
Yeah. I think it might be. She doesn't like anybody else, so he's got his own beating heart.
It's just another dead character.
No, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to do something more interesting. She
specifically asked for a girl.
I've got Steve in one hand now and my heart in the other.
Pretty much, he hands you a little sort of almost refrigerated box because you feel something weird go in your chest and your heart. Magically, it's still keeping everything going in your body. But when you open the box, you know that that's your heart in the box.
Pretty cool.
What's in the box?
Rodney's going to be like, I was so hoping he was going to be the same as the green guy.
May not. I'm just trying to be a lot stronger than him.
No, I think we've gone through enough characters tonight.
Yeah. Cool. Let's get out of here.
Hey, I ate a heart recently. Is that one you going did. Spare?
No. I think I need this one.
But you're going to have to figure out some way to put that back in your body.
No, it's just going in my inventory.
I'm going to come up with something. Over the next week, that it's going to mean like for you not to have your heart in you anymore. If you just said, "I don't mind about the wanted poster," this wouldn't be happening right now.
Well, I wouldn't be a Rooney.
I mean, in fairness, Rodney does have Smith's tools, so he can maybe turn in part of Cyborg.
I need somebody to be dancing around saying, I've got a jar there, I've got a jar there.
Box with a frozen
But anyway, you are in this room. You've got Will, who's trying to get himself free. You've got Sow Pig with a lizard in the corner that you want to get.
I'm going to go take
Sow Gabba Pig. That lizard. Has... Mm. Fair enough. At this point, Will breaks free and goes, ha ha, it was all a trap, and now we will destroy you. Everybody roll for initiative.
I left.
Yeah, that's the best plan. Will's going to turn into his true, like, Oni form. But still good.
I mean, I like the fact he's still good, but...
Off to the Twitch channel, see what he looks like.
What, Will of the Feywild? Mm-hmm. Well, he doesn't look like an Oni on this. I can display it in roll 20. Hang on.
This might be the best initiative rolls we've actually had.
And it's, yeah, well.
Yeah, good. We can go Sow Pig. Will of the Feywild.
Yeah. He looks a bit like, oh, what's his name? Was in Community and is like a rapper as well.
What do you mean?
But with more hair. Like when he's a rapper, like he's Little Chico or something called like that is his rapper name. I can't remember.
Not Donald Glover.
That's it, yeah.
Like Danny Glover's grandchild or some shit.
No? Yeah, something like that. Mm.
Oldish Gambino.
Mm. Anyway, so you are all now in initiative. You've got a very angry Granny Nightshade. You've got Will of the Feywild, who's on your side now, technically. You do have Squirt. You can run away now. You've got good Steve back. It is your choice, but it is in initiative order. So, bloody hell, it's a Rooney first.
Yeah, I'm not really sure what happened. A Rooney.
No.
Absolutely confused. He's standing in front of Sam, so he's just taking Steve. He's got to take the opportunity to try and slash Sow Pig, surely.
Just fair enough.
She looks very weird.
Mm. Yeah, easily hits.
8 damage.
It's a fairly good swing on her, to be fair. Not enough to, you know, it's, yeah, not enough to kill her or anything, but it's a good hit on her. Anything else?
Probably just going to shout, are we getting out of here? And then book it to the doorway.
Yeah. As long as you're all holding together while Aruni rubs off Squirt,
you can
teleport away.
Book it through the doorway.
The question is Will come with us or is he being left behind?
Aren't we supposed to be using the keys to save the kids?
Yeah, that's why I need to give the keys to somebody in here. That's why I was coming.
Will's like, I've got this. You guys get going if you've got more important things to do. I'm going to take this bitch down.
All right,
because he's got proper gangster at this point.
I'm
well, camp gangster.
The door. I guess I'm taking an attack opportunity from...
Yeah, you will be doing. Hang on. I'm sure this is going to do a lot. There we go. Try and claw you. Tries to claw you, fluffs it. Sweeper.
This is on Big Girl. Magic missiles. Pew, pew, pew.
Go for it.
Who are you doing that?
Piggy. Creepy Piggy.
Yeah, this might actually do it, to be fair, depending on your next two. 4, 5, 6, 7. No, it's not going to do it. No, not quite. Good, good. But Salpig's not down. She sort of sways as she gets battered by these magic missiles.
Bye.
Through the door. Excellent. Rodney.
I don't know if Rodney dies.
Yeah, just so I've got a bit of a clearing, I'm going to throw a hand axe at Sour Pig's head.
Go for it. That is just an AC, her AC, but unfortunately, because it's a hand axe and you're a little bit far away, tell you what.
Run.
Just to retcon that a bit, do you want to move a little bit close to the door, because you can skirt round this way without taking any opportunity attacks.
Yeah.
And then when you get to within 20 foot of Salpig, you can then throw an axe. She's up here at the minute. Yeah. So, yeah, that'll hit.
Okay, and let me see. And that's...
Yeah! That's a good hand axe. Yeah. This girl, well, goblin-y sort of girly figure-ish thing with a pig's face just gets an axe through the forehead and goes down.
So, question, can I quickly retrieve my hand axe on the way out the door?
You'd have to make the movement. Let me just measure that. So you've made 20 foot. 10 foot. No, you wouldn't be able to. Well, I mean, you could go and retrieve the hand axe.
You won't make it out the door.
But then you'll have to wait for your next turn to make it out the door.
Yeah, I'll take a chance on that.
Okay. That's fine. So, yeah, you move yourself next to Sour Pig, and then... there you go. And the next turn, you can make your way out the door. It's her turn, but she's dead. Will of the Feywild is immediately going to come into melee range of Scabatha. Try and beat her up a bit.
Get her, Will!
It doesn't work very well.
Ah, he's pretty strong. Yeah, so he does 11 damage and 12... 13, 14, 15, 16 damage. So 11 out of 16 is 27 to her.
Blimey,
yeah. Not bad for a short guy.
No.
Okay.
Rodney's just thinking, this guy's a lunatic, and he literally let me hog time.
Glint, why are you on there twice? Is that because you ran away? I can't remember. But Glint. You're not on there twice.
I can't see me on there twice.
No. Just on there once. It's just you're on 16 and then it's Scabbereth on 3. But
that's because that was the worst one.
Oh, yeah, it really was, wasn't it? God, yeah.
Of all of us,
yeah. I just thought we were back to the top because it was a 16. Sorry, Glenn.
Got the kids out of the kitchen earlier?
No, but Will's going to take care of things from now on.
Oh, he's going to get all the kids out, is he?
Well, that's his plan.
I'm going to give the keys over to the kid that stole the key last time.
Mm.
I guess it's time for us to leave then.
Mm.
I guess so.
I'll come back to the group so that they can start with the oil can.
Where's New Boy?
Because Nat disappeared off with the unicorn horn, there isn't actually really much interesting for you guys to do here anymore.
Good old Skylar.
That's it for me, I think.
Yeah. Well, that's fine. All right. Scabatha is going to wail at will. Yeah, so, oh no, that misses. That one hits, so Will's taken 26 poison damage. That's cool. Right. Aruni, are you doing anything? Oh yeah, you're stood in the doorway, aren't you? So yeah, you can still blast off something if you want to. Or just sort of huddle together and hold your oil can.
I mean, Rodney, hurry up. God's sake. Will, are you okay? He's gonna walk.
I'm fine. You guys get gone. You've done your part.
And then I'm going to walk into the room, throw some keys at somebody, and prepare to rub an oil can when Rodney finally gets here.
Sorry, stuck in traffic.
Sweeper.
I'll just stay where I am.
Mm-hmm.
Do we really want to wait for the new guy?
Okay, Rodney.
Yeah, I'm just going to make my way to the others.
Need to wave. You can't wave, they can't see you. Oh, right, okay. There's a door, that's fine. So we'll just quickly get back to Aruni. Just let me do a few attacks, just in case anything really massively exciting happens, which it won't.
Kill Scabatha, kill Scabatha. Kill your own big bad.
I really don't think that's going to happen in one turn. Takes another 11 damage. Glint, anything you want to do?
Nope.
Scabatha quickly... does no damage on Will. Aruni! Squirt goes, hey! I'm ready to go if you guys are.
What do I need to do?
All you need to do is give us a rub, and when I squirt some stuff out, we can get gone.
Here we go, man.
And Aruni's just like holding... Oh, God. Oh no, and just rubbing squirt while pointing it at Rodney.
Fair enough. This animated oil can maintains eye contact with you the entire time.
Oh, no. I'm just going to turn my head and face a different wall.
Oh, I'm going to squirt on your back now, it's fine.
Oh no, I've only turned my head, I'm not actually turned completely away.
And as you get to the end of what you're doing, he goes, hey, that was great fun, but to be honest, next time you just need to wish and say you can go to Yon.
Rodney's going to look at Aruni and go, you fool.
Are you going back to the hot air balloon to go to the next
place? No, this can just magically get you there. It's the wonderful thing about Squirt. When he's got the bog oil in him, he teleports you.
Don't we need to get back to the air balloon to go back to hither?
Yeah, there'll be a way to come back later.
Yeah.
For now, okay. Let's just get out of here before Scabatha kills Will and then kills us. Squirt, stop being a little squirt and get us out of here.
But yeah, Squirt goes, well, where do you want to go? I can take you to Yon, or I can take you down to where the scarecrow, Clapperclaw, was parked his hot air balloon.
I mean, why would we want to go there?
Because either way, there's only 10 minutes left, so it's just
a piece of... Let's go to Yon.
It's up to you. You know you got... Square goes, you know you got... I'll try and do Mr. Hanky. You know you can... You've got to... Oh, no, I can't do it. It's getting late now. You probably got time if I come with you to... hither to drop those paintings off so you don't get cursed. Or... we can go straight to Yon to make sure you don't miss the solar eclipse.
Really want to kill her. Don't want to miss the solar eclipse.
I mean, he reckons we've got time.
You do have time. Unless anything really horrible happens.
All we're doing is dropping some paintings off and going.
Fine, pain as it is. Let's go to Clapperclaw.
Fair enough. I'll whip you up there. Aruni, I'm afraid you changed it. You're going to need to rub me again.
Not happening. It's not happening.
Well, but... you can't blame a little animated old cat for trying.
I really can't blame you.
And yeah, you poof out of here, and you will appear at Clapperclaw's balloon. And he'll go, oh, you ready to go back to Thither?
I think so. And we probably need to be quick, because Scabatha is not happy with me.
That's fair enough. I'll take you quickly back to the palace, and then onwards to Yon with your help of your animated oil can. It's getting late now. My accents are just all over the place. I do apologise.
Yeah, that's fair.
And yeah, I know it's like a few minutes early, but that is a sensible place to end the session.
Yeah, agreed.
I think that was probably a bit messy in the second half, because I thought Illyria trying to kill everybody would take a little bit longer than it did.
She ran away too quick.
You beat her up a little bit more than we were both expecting. Well, actually, you didn't beat her up more. Glint blinding her and you restraining her sort of put the end to that, really, didn't it? Hello?
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 You all right?
Yeah. Oops.
Nikki, you all right? You were so quiet for that second half.
She's traumatised.
I'm fine.
Are you really that traumatised? Sorry.
To be fair, I've played in a game with Nikki before this one, and the group then managed to traumatise her as well.
She's fine. She's just plotting her demise.
Yeah, that's fair enough. That's sort of what I expect.
I was just plotting my revenge.
Yeah, no, that's good. Revenge is good. You will shout at me by the year is out.
It's just like episode 22, Sweeper's Meltdown.
Yeah. But things do get a little bit darker from now on. And there isn't really any sort of, oh, I'm just going to knock you out and put you in prison.
Benji says heart ripped out.
Yeah, well, yeah, I mean...
I'm not really sure it can get any more sinister than that.
Yeah, that wasn't actually my idea, that one. That you can blame that entirely for that one. For a lady that's about to go on a Disney cruise, she scares me.
She will hear from Benji's lawyer.
Mm. Yeah. So we've raided out. Mm. I think. We raided out?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, cool.
Cool.
Yeah, thank you. Hope that was all right.
Yeah, that was good. It was good.
Especially